bump sweet swizzle sticks.
There's a snake in here.
There's a snake in my face.
Oh, in my boots. Right, I remember that.
There's a snake on this plane.
Oh, wow. That'd be a cool mixture of movies.
Pretty sure that's how Samuel L. Jackson said it.
Yeah. That's what I want is we've reached the point where you can have mashup music. Why can't I have mashup movies?
Oh, I'm sure AI could do that for you.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
I want in. I want to watch Toy Story.
Yeah. Oh, I bet you AI could do that. You'd like feed it a million Woody lines.
Oh, yeah.
And then you just say, now replace all of Samuel L. Jackson's lines with with Woody.
That'd be great. That'd be so... Yeah, AI's going to get there at least soon if it's not there already.
Totally. Alex is here. Hi, hi.
I'm really sad to report that Laser Lords does not have achievements.
Oh.
Like, I wonder if when we're playing games that don't, if we should be taking notes of things that should be achievements.
Yeah, it's a cool thing you found on Steam, on the Steam Deck.
Oh, yeah, an Emu Deck. Yeah, they have retro game achievements. And
yeah.
It's just attached to an old website that you join, and it's the website that's responsible for it.
So, like, anybody can contribute the achievements to the website.
Yeah, I think so, yeah. But I wonder if there's a vetting process. But if we're just the ones submitting all the achievements for Nuts Games, they're never going to question us.
No, for sure.
Yeah.
Like, they have to play the Nuts Games to to find out.
Like, do you make an achievement for Mr. Bones to beat it without dying, or is that just not even fun? No one can do that.
Yeah, like, I don't know. I'd want to keep them fun, personally. I don't like the ones that are just, like...
doable, yeah.
Yeah, I don't like the ones that are just insanely, like, hard.
Right. Yeah.
That's the one-hit ones especially are just boring. There's not fun.
But to a certain extent, arcade games, I can see it at least.
If they're short, sure, yeah.
Yeah. Or like, at least in an arcade setting, like back in the 90s, someone would have been like, oh, I can beat The Simpsons on one quarter.
Yeah.
And that would be, yeah.
True.
I could never do it.
That would be cool. That's cooler, actually, because that's like four lives or something. Like,
right.
I like that.
Yeah.
One quarter.
That's gotta be impossible.
All arcade ones would have to have that.
There's one no quarter. One who's ever beat one of the Konami beat 'em ups on one credit.
Oh, I bet you.
It's just too much. It's just, you just have to be hit constantly just by being in it.
No, I remember, I think we looked at one of them. And it was insane the way they just, like, managed to stay just below the bosses and stuff.
Right. I know, and I've seen one credit clears of Double Dragon.
Oh, yeah. Like, that's insane.
Yeah, that's... Yeah. It's true. You basically just cheat.
Yeah. Like, you must just have to play it for years.
Forever. I was watching a video of a Dark Souls speed run, but it was about how the speed run is done, which was interesting.
Yeah.
And some of the tricks are so insane where you like have to save and quit in certain frames of animation and rejoin. Like, who's testing this stuff in the first place to find out these tricks?
Exactly. And people are, they're like, yeah, like saving and quitting in every frame just
constantly.
To make sure. Just constantly just hoping one of them will do something. Yeah.
Yeah, and they can be the guy who finds the new speedrun technique. I don't even know. It's just
and then
weird.
There's, I guess, communities, like forums people post on and share these.
Or do they look at, like, do they go to, like, the FromSoft, like, forums and look for people having technical issues and look at, like, I broke my game this way. And then they try and replicate that thing.
That would be a smart way to do it. They must do it. There must be some degree of that.
Maybe, backwards engineering stuff.
Yeah. Yeah, certainly about it must be accidental.
It has to be. It's just baffling the things that people do.
Yeah. Yeah, it's not completely.
Things must have been revealed to them by developers or...
I don't even know. And how much of the, like, I don't know, how much of the code do they know at this point?
That's true.
It's,
I think,
like,
you can
the game,
just access it.
The game you're about to play.
Yeah.
In the segment that we're going to do is... ground up, like, built original. Yeah, totally. It's original code.
Yeah.
It's Mario. Mario 64's code so completely that they're able to like build a copy of it from scratch.
Yeah. But I bet the developers of this game wouldn't know the techniques to speedrun their own game. They wouldn't know where those seams are and stuff yet, probably. Mm. I don't know.
The guy who made it seems like the kind of guy who would.
Oh, he just knows everything through and through, and he's right.
But yeah, you're right though. There probably are glitches he doesn't know about that someone could test and just
totally
access.
It's crazy. It's a weird world.
Yeah, like I feel like I rarely stumble upon a glitch that helps me out, like that moves me forward at all.
It's true. I just in general, I rarely stumble upon glitches, but then like when I do, it's just like, oh fuck, I have to reset. It's never.
Yeah, exactly.
What a great thing.
Or yeah, like that screwed me over.
Yeah. That'll be
somebody enemy clips under the ground or something.
Oh,
in
yeah.
games. It's like that kind of stuff. It's like, it doesn't, you know, there's no advantage to me.
No, it's true.
Or like a corpse just floats there or something. It's like, oh.
I don't think. That's a glitch. My brain doesn't start going, how can I use this?
Yeah, exactly. Okay, now that I'm going to go over to that corpse and just like jump on it 20 times and see if anything happens and then press start 20 times and.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's ludicrous.
I gotta reload and see if I can replicate that corpse floating there. Yeah. I don't get it. Yeah.
That's why we're not speedrunners.
That's it.
Someday. Someday we'll do it.
Well, we'll do it, yeah, for games that very few people.
And then no one else cares to do it.
Yeah. Exactly.
Yeah. But then evidently even this fan game, someone cared enough to do it.
Oh, yeah, it's hard. I think, I don't know. I don't know if we could find a game that no one has done a speedrun for. Remember Wacky World of Golf had like 2 speedruns.
Oh, that is insane. Yeah.
Yeah.
It's got that. We'd have to find something that is not only weird and alternative, but also really boring that no one would have tried to do.
Yeah.
Thought maybe we could do a speed run of what's her name's World of Birds.
Maybe Shelley Duvall. Yeah,
Shelley Duvall's World of Birds.
Maybe. I don't know what that is. It's like that's more of a movie,
an experience.
I don't know.
I don't know.
Like
we gotta play it someday.
Tender
really
Love and Care
to. Yeah,
I mean, I think somebody there was a speed run of that
because you can skip the movies in it.
Yeah, exactly.
So, that just sounds horrible. I don't want to play that.
Yeah, no, exactly. That's what Shelley Duvall's thing would have to be, too, probably.
Right. Yeah, it's how fast can I navigate these menus?
Yeah, exactly.
But then there are...
If they're skippable.
There's like... Yeah, oh, I hope they're not skippable. That would be the best.
Yeah. Someday.
We'll get there. Yeah.
That's on the 3DO?
That's on the 3DO, I think, yeah.
Yeah.
That sounds right. It's either on the CDI or the 3DO.
Oh, right. I think it was CDI, actually, yeah.
I
always get those two confused.
Oh, no, it is the 3DO. You were right.
Oh, there we go.
But maybe it's on other systems, too. I'm glad it's on the 3DO, because the 3DO emulator works a lot better than the CDI emulator. Right. Yeah. Oh, and it doesn't have achievements, so we could also come up with achievements as we went through it.
Wow. I'm really curious.
Oh my god, I've seen too much. It's the greatest game I've ever seen.
There's a, just for what you've seen, don't look anymore.
I already stopped it.
But does it look, from what you've seen, did it look like there was a game there?
Oh, wow. No.
Yeah.
Based on what I saw, it might just be a slideshow of photographs. But of right. Shelley Duvall with birds.
Wow.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That'll be a fun one.
Yes, let's speedrun that.
Yeah. Well, we'll play that one of these days on stream. Absolutely. Especially after seeing that, I really want. I'd never opened that game up before.
Oh, man.
It's exciting, yeah.
Yeah.
I bet it's really boring, actually, too.
Yeah.
But...
yeah, and we'll be down in like 10 minutes. Like, well, totally. That was Shelley Duvall's trip to Albuquerque.
Like, I bet the game was probably made for like a bird sanctuary somewhere that they could play it for like kids that came.
Yeah, it was an educational thing. Yeah.
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 That's ridiculous. Yeah, Shelley Duvall seems like we could get a celebrity of that caliber to narrate something for us.
Shelley Duvall is like, shot
in. She was in some of the greatest movies of all time.
Yeah,
so it's,
she's like a shut in now. Like,
was she already a shut in?
No.
Right.
What? No.
I don't know.
She got her out and made her do movies.
No.
Made her a star.
Is she still alive? I didn't know she was still
alive. I think she did a movie recently, actually. Someone did get her out to make her do a movie, but it was like really exploitive.
Make her do a movie. Oh, I thought that wasn't it like a Dr. Phil interview or something that was really exploitative.
That
with
too,
her?
Yeah.
Bananas. But and then like people like would say that like, well, who wasn't it working with Stanley Kubrick was what ruined her? But I think that's nonsense.
No, it certainly doesn't look like a good experience. But
no. Unless, yeah, some people love it, but most people it just seems bad.
Yeah.
She was in some crazy stuff. That Popeye movie was something else.
Yeah.
And she really is the living embodiment of olive oil.
Yeah.
That's nuts.
That's Shelley Duvall.
That's Shelley Duvall.
Who covered that. That's
absolutely
done.
Well, when we play her game, we'll definitely talk more about Shelley Duvall.
We'll get deeper into it.
Yeah.
Hey, Tiny.
What's happening? I'm all right. I'm just drugged up and, you know, fine. I'm just hanging out. It's weird how surgery's hard on your body and you don't do anything, you get really tired.
Right, it just takes energy to heal.
Apparently, which is fucking bullshit.
Yeah.
I wish we lived in the world of Starship Troopers, where they can just put me in, like, some goo, and it would make me better right away.
Yeah, probably.
Though that's probably the only reason I wish we lived in the world of Starship Troopers.
Yeah.
Oh, I bet it smells fantastic.
Yeah. Watermelon.
Yeah. It did. Yeah. It was like, yeah, Jolly Rancher watermelon colored.
Yeah. Or fresh apple.
That, if it's apple, that sounds torturous. But if it's watermelon, it sounds great. I feel like that apple is almost like acidic and getting that all over your body.
Too
would
much
be...
apple.
Maybe. Yeah.
Maybe add some cinnamon, ooh, though, to that apple.
Oh, God. It's the new form of cinnamon challenge.
Of a goo bath in cinnamon apple. That's the future.
Oh, man. That would be a great future. If once you don't have to see the doctor anymore, just once every 6 months you have to take a goo bath in cinnamon apple, and that keeps you healthy.
Yeah.
I'd do it.
Sounds great.
Yeah.
Hot cinnamon apple.
You mean in temperature or spicy?
No, the temperature. Goo. Yeah, the goo is hot.
Right.
In temperature.
Who? How hot? Like
not
hot
too, not,
temperature?
No. Like comfortably warm. Like yeah.
Sure. Like a nice blanket. You crawl into.
Yeah. Exactly.
Yeah, that'd be great.
Yeah.
It would be. Maybe it's the goo. It's like the goo in the abyss, where you have to like drink it into your lungs and then you can breathe the goo.
Yeah, exactly.
From that moment
it's on. Enough that there's a little bit of steam coming off the goo.
Oh, that'd be so cool.
Yeah. Hot apple cider steam. Goo
steamy
steam.
Goo is the
hot apple cider
probably,
goo steam.
It would probably smell really good to like, because someone probably has to come and retrieve you from the goo. That's the deal with it, because it's, you become unconscious once you're in the goo, I think.
Right. Yeah.
So someone has to come in, but it probably smells really good in that room.
You probably just have like a robot, like, yeah.
That's like, oh, yeah.
It's like around your waist. And
totally. Or for us lay people, that there might just be after a timer goes off, the drain just unplugs and you just end up naked in a tub.
We wake up.
Yeah, startled.
Steamy.
Why does it smell like apple pie?
It smells like apples. But
whatever was going wrong, you'd feel great.
Yeah, you're not hurt anymore.
No.
You know that much.
Yeah, basically that's what I want.
That's going to happen.
Then I'd feel really good right now.
People
absolutely
like flavored things.
It's true. People don't like non-flavored things.
It's the future, exactly. Flavor is the future.
I have a lot of weird vitamins that are all kinds of crazy flavors.
Yeah, exactly. I didn't used
what
to
a nuts
that.
World. No. Yeah, they used to just be sour sweet flavor or no flavor
evolved,
at all.
Exactly. To flavors.
Now there's like some really good chocolate ones that are so they just taste so good. I'd eat them as candy weren't really bad for you to just eat candy.
I know. There's like the vitamin C ones. Those like vitamin C chewables. Those like orange.
Oh,
ones.
Yeah.
Those are like, I could eat those as candy.
I got ones called Gorgeous Sleep, which I thought was a hilarious name, that are one of the best raspberry gummies I've ever had.
And they're what? A vitamin?
They're like melatonin.
Right.
Other things to help you sleep.
That's hilarious. They're just candy.
But like, it's just such a good, candy that I could eat a whole bunch. But that's probably not a great thing to do.
Oh yeah, Tiny's Mod Flanders likes non-flavored things. Yeah, the Flanders in general.
Oh yeah, give me plain, please.
Yeah, Flanders likes just a unbuttered plain loaf of bread with a glass of water on the side for dipping.
Dipping.
Yeah.
Oh, that's so gross.
Dip that.
She's still dead, right?
Yeah.
They never brought her back. Okay.
No, I don't think she came back to life.
Right. Too bad. See, yeah. Yeah, that. I can't even imagine eating wet bread as food.
Oh.
What a gross sensation.
It really is.
Because bread can take on a lot of water, probably.
Yeah. Yeah. Maybe a couple glasses.
Oh, gross.
I think it was actually plain white bread, he said.
Right.
Bread.
Plain white bread for me.
Like, there's no fanciness, no nuts in there. The work of the devil. For sure. Tiny hasn't watched that show in a long time. Those first like 10 seasons will hold up for all the time.
Does season one hold up still? I don't know.
I don't know that it ever really did, but you know what I mean.
Right. Yeah. Yeah.
Like
yeah.
I would go I would narrow it down to 5 seasons.
2 to 12.
Three to eight.
Or yeah. Yeah, that's their prime.
As being the absolute prime that can never. Yeah.
And then, I think it was 12 where they go to Japan. So there was still. And Tamako was that season. There was still good stuff for a while.
Totally. There's still good stuff now.
But there's no fully good episodes anymore.
Probably not. I haven't watched it. I haven't watched the new stuff in a long time. But
yeah.
I bet you this.
Well, they have a lot of one-off episodes now, too, that are like 15 minutes on Disney Plus.
Right. That's weird.
Where it's like The Simpsons meet Billie Eilish or Elton John or.
Weird.
Like in the past, those would have just been guests on an episode.
Huh.
It's strange.
Yeah. Weird. Yeah.
Yeah. It's like, even the bad episodes of The Simpsons, I still like having The Simpsons on because I love The Simpsons character. Like, I just love Bart and Homer and Maggie and Bart
exactly
and the other one.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And they'll still probably make you laugh at least like once or twice.
Yeah, probably. Yeah. It
just doesn't have the same, tightness that it used to have.
No, everything was three jokes at a certain point.
Yeah, exactly. Like, yeah. Three jokes like every minute. And it was all felt natural. It didn't feel like they were shoved in.
That's the thing. And now it's shoved in. Everything, like, you can see the, like, it's just there for the joke.
Yeah. Like, yeah, exactly. Where all the jokes, like, served the story and served the characters in the old episodes.
And they were still, like, heartfelt, too. And, like,
and still, like, filled with pop culture references. But they didn't feel like
they weren't dumb. They were
they were
referencing things that were already timeless. Is the smart
thing. Yeah, that's true. Yeah,
you can't reference current things because
that's true.
Who knows what'll be good? Yeah,
yeah.
Tiny remembers when they did that with Lady Gaga. Why didn't they write her a character? It's true. I'm surprised Lady Gaga hasn't had a character on The Simpsons. That's nuts.
Yeah.
Weird. So weird.
But it makes I would highly recommend going back and watching those first bunch of seasons. It's the best, still the best comedy writing on television of all time.
I wonder. That's tough.
Oh yeah.
There's a lot of good stuff.
Crazy good. Yeah.
I'd watch Mr. Show over all these early Simpsons, I think.
But I don't know if that's strictly for the writing. Like
oh yeah, that's true. It's good character. Like it's just good. Like at like yeah, over the top ridiculousness.
And, yeah, exactly. It's the performance.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah. And, like the more the concepts.
Yeah. It's true.
Simpsons. Yeah, it's just so like you said. It's like three jokes a minute. Like
yeah, there's some shows that had that same amount of jokes for
not
a while.
For five seasons.
That's the thing. No, like Arrested Development did it for like two of their seasons.
Yeah.
And like, yeah, there are ones that do it, but it's so hard to do it for long.
Yeah. That's the best.
It's crazy. Yeah. So and like Community almost did it, but Community also threw a lot of things at the wall that never stuck. Like,
yeah.
They were just, we'll do every joke. And some of it'll be incredible and some of it just isn't.
Yeah. It took them a while to find their thing. For sure.
Oh, yeah. It's true.
Because by the time it ended, it wasn't about a community college at all. It was about it's about a show about shows.
Yeah, it's true.
It's a show about
vaguely took place at a community college, but not even really.
Yeah, by the end.
Yeah.
It was like yeah.
That's I really hope they make the Lego set. That would
Danny asks if she watches Community, should she start at the beginning?
Season one is kind of like a good, bad sitcom.
Yeah, exactly. I would still say so. But like,
yeah.
It only really starts getting interesting in season two.
Yeah.
There's a few episodes of season one where you can like see it coming.
Yeah.
And the paintball episode. I think
I was already a big fan of Community as it was airing in season one. So like I liked it a lot at the time.
Yeah, like it's a solid sitcom in season one.
Yeah. Totally.
And then there's a few crazy sparks like the paintball episode where you're like, whoa.
Right.
This show is something else.
There's some wacky people working on this show.
Yeah, exactly.
It'd be weird if they got control of it.
Yeah, and then slowly and it's very meta. Like Abed's one of the best characters of all time.
Yeah,
there's even parts I think like season three he's like, I've been noticing things are getting wackier and I think we should lean into it. Like
that's amazing.
Like it even when it is a bad sitcom, it knows it's a bad sitcom.
Totally.
It's like playing with those ideas.
Yeah.
And then it just starts to become every episode's wacky, and it's the perfect homage show. Like they're incredibly good at copying a style of another show and doing like an homage to that show.
Yeah, it's such a good cast. Everyone on it is so likable.
Yeah, that's the other thing too. It's like such funny people.
Yeah,
I love that show. Yeah,
totally. It's on the same level as oh man, I can't even, as Arrested Development and things like that. Like it's
yeah,
overall a top five sitcom ever.
Yeah, for sure.
Crazy.
The only thing, Tiny, is that you can't, there's one episode that you can't watch, the forbidden episode.
Oh,
one of the best ones too.
I bet it's pretty easy to find on the internet.
You'd have
if you
to download
want to.
It on the internet, yeah. Or yeah. Like maybe somebody, you can stream it somewhere.
What season was it on?
2, I think.
So it's on the DVDs as well, then.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. It's on the DVDs, yeah. For sure.
Yeah. Right.
Tiny asks, is there a Jim Pam type situation? Not really, but sort of. There's definitely...
The first season, there definitely is.
There's
like,
definitely love
setting it up as,
triangles and love, yeah, and couples. There's a thing at the end where it's like, where it's describing the show, and it's like characters will couple and uncouple, at random times, no matter what the fans want.
It's true, and the first season is about like Jeff and Britta, kind of, and then. They just let Britta become a really weird character from there on.
Yeah, but Britta and... yeah, for sure. But Britta the first and season, though, Troy date at one point.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Jeff and Amy date.
And who?
Is that not Amy? Isn't her name Amy? What was her name? Allison Brie's character.
Weird. That totally confused.
Maybe Amy. Probably not Amy, since that didn't sound right to you.
Yeah, it didn't sound right.
Jenny? I don't know.
Annie.
It's definitely not.
Annie
Yeah. Annie.
No, I don't think they do date.
Didn't they? I thought they did at one point. Huh.
But that's the thing. It's always like a will. There's lots of will they won't days.
Right.
But anyway, no, Tiny, it's not clowns. It's an awesome, it's a really good episode on Dungeons and Dragons.
Yeah.
That was only banned because it had blackface in it, sort of.
Ken Jeong in blackface. Yeah. In dark elf face.
That's the thing. It was like, yeah. It was like he was being, he was trying to play a dark elf.
Yeah.
And he went too far.
He went too far. Ridiculous.
But so it was like, yeah, like pitch black. Face like
is that the one with Pierce's son, or is that a different episode? They're in the video game. That's a different thing.
Oh, yeah, that's a different episode. That's the video, that's the game.
Right?
Yeah, and they,
yeah, that's
yeah,
crazy.
Yeah, no, so no one can watch it. It's not on any streaming services or anything.
It's on, yeah, it's on. Oh, that one episode is, yeah, right, yeah. Totally.
Yeah. Like, that's too bad. The rest of the episode, like that joke, like happens at the beginning, and then he literally dies and gets kicked out of the episode within 5 minutes.
Yeah.
And like, it's actually one of the character calls it out too. Is like one of them's like, no one's gonna mention that this is racist. And then he dies, and the rest of the episode is like this really great story about bullying. And so it's too bad. Like, it's not a great joke. It's not worth having in there. It's too bad that it's in there at all. But it's too bad the episode, the whole episode to go, because it's
gone forever.
It's one of the best ones. It's amazing.
Crazy.
No, that wasn't super smart of them.
Too bad.
Yeah. So it goes.
Yeah,
but it's worth, the episode's worth seeking out if you find it.
Do you ever watch any of Harmon Quest?
No,
that was pretty entertaining, and it sort of struck similar notes, like not with the same characters, but it was some good D&D ridiculosity in sitcom form.
Right? Wasn't it like a podcast forever?
I think so. Yeah,
played D&D. Yeah.
Yeah, and then they did they did it where they played it in front of a live audience, and it got animated.
I knew a bit of it. I watched Harmon Town, I think it was called. It was like a documentary,
right,
about him,
and that's also a podcast.
That was really interesting. That was an interesting documentary. Yeah, yeah. I went into that show a lot at the D&D podcast, and then one of the main guys from that is in one is in an episode of Community.
Right.
The like super nerdy guy.
Spencer Crittenden. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Totally.
Yeah. But yeah. It's awesome. I'm always just like Law and Order. That episode's crazy. Seven.
Yeah. What was the Seven episode?
There's a the Ass Crack Bandit trying to find who is dropping coins down people's. Oh, it's completely an homage to Seven.
Just
watch it again. It's like it's raining all the time, and it's like the whole episode's like that bleak, washed out sort of cinematography.
That's funny.
It's so good.
Wasn't there a My Dinner with Andre episode?
Oh, that episode's so good, yeah.
Yeah.
Where Ovid talks to me about his time on the set of Cougar Town. And he was, and then they actually did put him on the set, like, have him as an extra on Cougar Town.
That's super weird. But, like, just an extra. Isn't he, like, literally just at the side of a shot at some point?
Yeah, and then he just gets up and runs away.
That's so weird. Yeah,
that's great. So, I love that show.
It's a funny show. I'll tell you what.
Hey, here's some weird news. This is an awesome story that Kotaku ran. A YouTuber from Japan has this gimmick where he made a controller for their pet fish.
I don't understand.
Just like wherever. You never seen that kind of thing?
But how can a fish control something?
Wherever they like swim to. It's like it detects these like the areas they swim to, and then that corresponds to different buttons.
Interesting.
And they were playing Pokemon.
Yeah.
And somehow there's usually just one fish doing it.
But yeah.
The owner walked away from the game and multiple fish took over. And then because Pokemon has so many performance issues, it crashed. I went to his homepage.
Yeah.
Went to the main Nintendo Switch page, opened up the eShop where it exposed his credit card information.
What?
Added 500 yen to the account and then bought a golfing cosmetic for Nintendo Switch Sports.
That sounds too insane to be real.
Amazing.
Holy shit.
It's just
crazy.
Total randomness. Total chaos.
The fish knew what they were doing.
Yeah, completely. They wanted that. They knew exactly what cosmetic they wanted.
Wow. That's really ridiculous.
That's so
and it funny. Happened on stream?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, like his credit card doxed.
That's crazy.
Yeah. Huh. That's hilarious.
It's
like when Twitch played Pokemon. It's that just like randomness that somehow and like can result in
progress. Oh yeah. Huh. That's the thing. You just can't trust animals, even.
That's for sure. Especially fish.
Yeah. That's the moral of the story.
They will eat you.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Enough. They hate us. Yeah. They're just waiting for you to die in their water.
That's all they do is just sit and stare at you and, like, try to eat you, but they can't.
Yeah. Fantasize about eating humans. Yeah.
That's why they make that, like,
yeah.
Like they open their mouth like that.
Yeah. Up eating at me. I'll usually, if I'm in a room with fish, I'll point and yell at them. And then they usually stop.
Yeah. Good.
You're not eating me, you stupid fish.
I just chomp back at them. And that scares them.
Yeah. Or I point to one and get the chef to pull it out and cook it for me.
Whoa, that's harsh.
Exert dominance.
Let's make an example.
Yep. Exactly. If you guys chomp at me, I'm going to chomp on you.
Wow. Just eat it right in front of the tank.
Yep. That's true. I wonder if fish can recognize a cooked fish as a fish. Probably.
Fish being fishy, says Tiny. It's true. That's some fishy behavior.
Yep. It really is.
Yeah, that's a great story.
Place. It would have been hilarious to be watching, but did it happen over, like, hours?
Probably. I don't know. It says he just walked away, so maybe, like, I don't know if it crashed immediately after he walked away.
Interesting.
It was probably, like, I don't know about, yeah, like, I didn't explain, like, why a bunch of fish. There's only one, but when he left, a bunch of fish took control.
Yeah. It would scare the other fish away
if they ever tried to. And maybe because of that, like, there was just a bunch of button presses happening at the same time, and so that's why it crashed.
Probably. They Alt-Control-Deleted out accidentally.
Yeah. And then it was just, a matter of time from there.
Well, just think how famous he would have been if he'd walked away and came back and the fish had beaten Pokemon.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Those fish would be more famous.
That's true.
He'd always be living in the shadow of those fish.
That's the thing. I would want to eat one of the fish that beat Pokemon.
But, yeah, how much would you pay? That's the thing.
Yeah, there's other people who are going to be bidding with me. It's very rare that you can eat something that can beat Pokemon. Exactly. So it's, that's how you know you've made it.
That's the dream.
Yeah. Either raising a cow to be smart enough to play Pokemon or a human, I guess.
Yeah. Well, yeah, they made that, like, bit of brain that could play Pac-Man.
Oh, yeah. We're getting there.
Yeah. Just eat little brains.
It's true. I've never eaten anything that can beat Pac-Man either. Well, not even. I don't think that brain could beat Pac-Man. No one can beat Pac-Man.
No.
Crazy. Yep. Very much so.
I came across an interesting little story today. Mm-hmm. We go to this retro game site called CD Romance, which is a great name.
Yeah,
it's like CD Romance.
Oh, they love the romance.
And there's like two prototypes up there, and it's these guys that used to work at Acclaim, and they got together and made a Metroidvania, or at the time they were sad that there was no Metroid game. And so they wanted to make a Metroid for the Game Boy Advance. And so they made like a prototype and they pitched it to Acclaim and they weren't interested.
Oh. So
these guys went on to be in some interesting companies. Kynan Pearson is one of the guys' name. He joined Retro Studios.
Interesting.
He did end up making Metroid games. Ian Dunlop. That sounds like a name I know for some reason. Mm. But he did freelance work for Way Forward Technologies and runs his own company. And this other guy started Renegade Kid, which released Moon and Mutant Muds.
Oh, yeah. Okay, I know those guys.
Zeo Drifter. Yeah. So anyway, kind of interesting people. But there's these two prototypes that they released now that you can play, and they, like, one of them looks really cool. It's called Dark Eden.
Oh.
And it is totally just Metroidvania.
Play on what system?
Game Boy Advance, all GBA, three of them.
Right.
The third one was actually a port of Demon's Crest.
Interesting.
Which is weird. But then, there was a Metroidvania called Dark Eden and a puzzle game called Sea Boy.
Ooh, that sounds fun.
It looks
fun.
Pretty fun, too. So I'll have to check them out one day on the stream.
Do they look, like, good?
They do. Like, they look like forgotten Game Boy games that, like, I wish I could play.
But they're probably pretty short if they're just prototypes, right?
Yeah. I think the one guy said, like, you get in, what's it called? Dark Eden, you get, like, 10 powers in 10 minutes.
Oh, geez, yeah. It's an ultra-compressed Metroidvania.
Yeah, but it looks slick.
Oh, yeah, Dark Eden, I see here, looks closer to, like, a Castlevania side of Metroidvania.
Yeah, totally. Yeah.
Interesting. Cool.
Yeah, and Seaboy.
Yeah, we should look at those someday.
Absolutely. I love stuff like that.
There's what's the third one called? Seaboy, Dark Eden, and...
Demon's Crest.
Oh, I don't even see that one here.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. It was... Right. Maybe I have a picture over here, yeah. Yeah.
Cool. I like stuff like that.
I know, me too.
Yeah.
Like that, like, remember we played a Steven Seagal prototype game?
Oh, yeah. That's show? True.
Amazing.
Polaroid Pete. It's a prototype game.
Yeah, that's true. Yep, yeah. Never actually got released.
Oh.
For some reason.
Yeah, I can't imagine. Actually, it was. It felt kind of polished and cool.
It's so weird. I mean, like, yeah, it makes sense that it would get released in Japan.
Yeah.
It's just so weird to me that Polaroid went so far in on it.
Totally.
As to, like, yeah put their brand on it and be like, yes, this is going to be good.
We like this. And they weren't, I don't think Polaroid's on the first game.
No. In Japan, I don't think it has anything to do with Polaroid. I feel like they, I don't know, we're just looking for a photographer. Or, yeah, somebody from Polaroid was like, hey, he takes pictures in that game.
Oh.
We run a picture-taking company. We make cameras.
We wish we would have gotten on board with Pokemon Snap, because that was so popular.
Oh, that was probably it, yeah.
Yeah.
It was just regrets from Pokemon Snap.
That's the thing. Yeah. Well, then Africa, I remember Kodak was all over Africa.
Right, yeah.
And I think Canon as well. So it had, like, that was one that had, like, real and fancy cameras
in it.
That's
so weird.
Yeah.
Did you, like, switch lenses in that game?
Yeah, you totally did. You had to get better lenses. Weird. It was too complicated. Game. Yeah.
We gotta play that game.
It's true. I remember it being super not fun.
I'm sure.
Like, it was like, it had just the worst stealth mechanics, but every picture was based on the stealth mechanics.
Right, you had to get close enough to get a good picture.
Yeah, and but, you'd like, always scare them away.
Anywhere near them and they get scared away. Perfect.
Yeah. I think probably like a late game save would be cool on it where you have upgrades and stuff.
Right.
I wonder how hard that would be to arrange.
Yeah, that's hilarious. Yeah, we got to play that for sure.
Yeah. Crazy.
But I guess for now we should play other games.
Oh, like that Mario game.
Yeah, we got. Yeah, and speaking of like CD Romance and mods and hacks and unreleased games.
Oh yeah!
Like we'd play if when we play those games, Dark Eden and Seaboy, we'd play them in Modification Station.
That's true. Like this.
That's what we're gonna play right now.
Yeah.
But we're not gonna play an unreleased game. We're gonna play a hack that somebody made from scratch.
But recently released? I think so.
Yeah, super recently, within the last couple of weeks.
I'm excited. If it's good and made by someone who loves Mario 64, maybe it'll be great.
It's exciting stuff. I'm excited to see it too. Let's get into it.
Yeah.
Modification Station. Yeah, I can hear it. Yeah. How's it going? Welcome to Modification Station.
Oh yeah, am I ready
there,
to
like,
start?
A title screen? I just can't remember what it's called.
No, this is where it boots to.
Oh weird. Oh right, it's like Mario Through the Ages.
Yes, that is what it's called. Yes.
Is there? I wonder if there is a.
It just booted right to here for some reason. So.
No, but like, oh no, I was thinking maybe.
Oh, on Twitch.
Twitch might even have that, but no.
If only. Wow. Oh, and it just puts you right in the game.
Cool.
Oh, okay. Yeah, controls like Mario. That's the first kind of jump I do in every Mario game to see if it plays right.
Oh, yeah? I think my favorite jump in 3D Mario is the side jump.
I'm not good at doing that. Like, I don't know how to do it.
Let's go to this. Just go left instead of forward.
He's not doing it.
You gotta wait till he does that weird kick. You know what I mean? Like, he kicks out of it.
No. Kicks out of the jump?
No, like he stops, like when he stops on like a hard stop.
Oh, that?
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, that's a pretty good jump.
I love that jump.
I did love the jump combo in Mario Odyssey. Doing the hat throw into long jump, into hat launch, into...
Oh, yeah. Yeah, the hat launch, the whole hat launch aspect of Odyssey was so much fun.
I will say it feels like... left and right are opposite of what I want them to be.
What? Hey, that's
look
a Banksy
at that beautiful piece of
reference.
The horizontals are inverted.
Oh, what? Weird.
Yeah. That's some kind of witch doctor.
I'm pretty sure his name is Kaze.
What's up, buddy? Can I hook you up with anything specific today? Check out my inventory and tell me what you'll need. I can't afford anything except for change partner. And I don't have a... Oh, because doesn't this have Pokemon in it, you said?
Yeah.
Right. Okay. Let's go into this first hole.
Yeah, I don't even know how to... I don't know how to pronounce his name. His name is Kaze Amanoir. Amanoir, maybe. Okay. His name is Kaze Emanuar.
Cool. He looks like he did a lot of work on this.
Yes, he's done lots of Mario 64 stuff. I watched the video of this that explained this, and this was exciting for him because it was the first time that he used code that was ground up built from scratch. So it's actually, this game is actually completely 100% legal.
But I feel like these sound effects for Mario are stolen still.
Maybe. I don't know how that works.
Oh, what's this? I don't know what I'm doing. I'm just going to the top of this.
Maybe just the code is, 100% legal. I don't know. Oh, that's awesome. It's almost like some Super Mario Land.
Yeah. Totally.
Oh.
I'm spending too much time stopping to look around.
Oh.
Fall out. Alright, bad start. Bad start. But it's fine. We got this. We gotta just go to the temple.
You're visiting historical locations, so I'm not sure what this one is, but it's pretty cool.
El Dorado.
Oh, cool.
Oh. But is El Dorado really a historical location?
Maybe.
How do you make that jump?
I think there's like space down the...
Oh.
That one platform. Like ramps down.
I wonder if I can just get up there. Oh, shit.
Tiny stepped away. What's modded in this? This is actually built from the ground up from scratch. This is a brand new game. Where Mario goes through the ages.
What is that even? That could be such a broad term.
He goes to various historical locations. And
times and places.
Yeah. There's 95 stars.
Wow.
Oh yeah, it's a full game.
Camera does feel a little finicky, but I think that's always kind of been Mario 64's thing.
Yeah.
Right? Yeah, okay. Do I want that?
Kind of cool music.
It doesn't seem to have a... Oh, I think I've gotten two achievements in the bottom right corner there, too.
Oh, yeah.
Trying to remember how you can go first person in this.
I think up on the C.
Yeah,
and then
that's
up again.
Yeah, that's as far as I can go.
Oh, that might be all there was, yeah.
Maybe. That's not the temple top. That's got to be the temple top, right? Yeah.
Yeah, this is cool, actually. It kind of reminds me of the pyramid level, but...
Oh, after you said it, I totally get Mario Land vibes from it, too.
Yeah, that's true.
Oh. You think there's 100 coin star, too?
Oh, yeah, good question.
Oh, there's a star here.
That might be the...
There's red. Definitely a red coin
yeah,
star.
Yeah, exactly. That might be the red coin star. Sounds like it's it's original music or oh wow.
That bird's got a star.
Yeah. His tail. He's probably you gotta get like a app, probably. Or a Pokemon or something.
Hey. Oh yeah, probably. You gotta fight for your right.
Here we
to have
go.
A star.
Oh, cool, and this is just your home base.
Maybe, yeah. This is just Mario. Are there old? So there might only be three worlds, then.
Yeah, cool. Or more might open up. There's a cannon.
Oh, there is a cannon.
Yeah, there's got to be more than three worlds, because there's probably going to be, like, 6 or 7 stars per world.
Yeah, that's true.
95 stars.
Okay, we're at Shipwreck Cove. I love this historical location.
This looks awesome.
This is great. Come on. There we go. Oh, boo!
Whoa. This ghosts of sailors fast.
Oh, no. Actual sailors. What is that?
That's awesome. Whoa. Paintings.
We got... That's the temple.
Yeah.
We got what looks to be a bomb on a book.
Already like a raft?
Oh, yeah, maybe a raft bomb and then a sunset.
Aww.
There was a skeleton with a do-rag.
Oh, was there? But it just disappeared?
No, I fell in a hole.
Oh, yeah, that's what I thought, yeah.
But
I didn't see the skeleton. Thought you meant the painting was a skeleton with a do-rag.
Oh, that would be great. I wish. Let's go investigate this skeleton. I should have looked at the name of the level. There he is.
Oh, yeah. The pirate skeleton.
Oh, I can't kick him.
He's spinning.
How do you kill booze again?
You have to get around him.
But that one's got a coin in him.
Yeah, you can punch them from behind, or you can run around them over and over again.
I thought it was the eyeballs you ran around.
I think the booze work that way too. Maybe not.
Oh no. Oh, I need some coins. Jeez. Right. Jeez. Come on. I should have looked at the title of this level. I have no idea what I'm trying to accomplish.
I wonder what this music's from. It's very Mario, but, like, not.
Oh, like, yeah, almost like a Bowser level.
Like Luigi's Mansion or something?
Yeah. Or I wonder if he just commissioned someone to make music.
Yeah.
Oh, that's...
Some info.
Oh, wow, it gets neat. The music.
Wow, he's done a million things. Yeah, it's crazy.
This is just the highest profile thing of his now.
Yeah.
Oh, going up. Uh-oh, what's that sound?
I remember when Super Mario 64 Chaos Edition came out.
What was that one?
It's just completely insane. It automatically activates and deactivates random codes at random times.
Oh, cool.
He also made an extreme edition.
I bet one of these paintings you can totally jump through.
He made Portal Mario 64.
Oh yeah, I've heard of that one. It sounds so much like a Luigi's Mansion song.
Yeah.
It's very good. Very good music. For a fan-made
One, there's one called Super Mario 64, The Last Impact. I think that was his first major hack that had 130 new stars.
Oh, but that was all based on original Mario 64.
And 12 like, power-ups. I don't know. No, like brand new. All brand new. Yeah.
Wow. That's crazy.
Super Sweet Sugar Land.
The shit feels really polished.
Yeah, well, so like this would be like polished. By now, like this list has a bunch of categories, and there's one for major hacks, which is what this is in.
Right.
And he's got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This would be the sixth. Actually, this.
Finally killed a ghost.
A lot of them sound really cool.
Interesting. I've never really thought about playing Mario 64.
There's one called Super Mario 64 Land that is like level based.
Oh, weird.
It's like World 2. 2 1, 2 2, 2 3, 2 4. 2 3 has an angry son.
Oh, wow. What a horrible game. What do you do about these fuckers? I'm feeling lost.
Based on some of these older ones, it sounds like it's music from other Mario games. Although, there's some other ones.
I just don't understand how to attack the skeletons.
Maybe a couple originals.
Yeah. You jump higher with the side jump than you do with the backflip? No, about the same. Yeah. Oh, yeah!
Oh, wow, he made one called Super Mario Odyssey 64.
Oh, I've seen that before, too.
Right, I don't know, I'm assuming.
It's Mario Odyssey levels in the Mario 64 engine, I thought.
Yeah, it's like a whole recreation / remix, I guess. But it doesn't have New Donk City.
What's the point then?
And some of the bosses are missing.
That's the bosses are the reason I play Mario games.
Interesting. I wonder. Yeah, so it probably doesn't incorporate Cappy, though. Although, maybe it would have to.
Oh, you're so slow with a bomb! Nope. I thought that's how I would open the treasure chest, but there's no way in hell you can get back to the treasure chest.
And there's also Super Mario 64 Ocarina of Time.
What's that?
All created by Kaze. It's a remake of Ocarina of Time, but made to fit in Mario 64 style.
Yeah.
171 stars. And it's just a giant linked together world. That sounds cool. All these sound fun.
They totally do. And, like, this play is totally solid. It feels a little like Nintendo has great level design. Like you never get lost in a Nintendo level.
Right. Yeah. This so feels you can like
feel the difference there.
A little more like PS2, like random PS2
totally, level design. Yeah.
Exactly. Platformer.
I don't know how I can get over there. Not like that.
Which isn't bad at all. It's just not like the magic.
No. Exactly. But
somehow, yeah, Nintendo. Where everything feels like perfectly designed to.
Yeah.
Like for the controller. Exactly. For how it controls.
Yeah. Yeah. Whereas now I'm completely lost. I just straight up don't know where to go in this.
I've been feeling that with some of the puzzles in Breath of the Wild. They're so well made.
Oh, yeah, totally.
Where, like, the solutions are so clever.
I bet I have to get that ball bomb over to that door. No, that seems way too far. The bombs explode really fast, and...
Yeah. Oh.
But I don't know if I can make that. I can.
There we go. There's a lantern up there.
I love lanterns.
And you've already won.
Right. That was my objective. It's a personal victory. All right. There's a switch. A knife. Oh, Mario needs a knife.
Oh, man. Aw.
Damn. This game sucks. 0 out of 10.
You just punch that down or something? Oh no, slippery slide.
Oh no!
That's devious.
That's actually better though, because now I don't have to. Oh shit! Oh man.
Oh,
that's a bummer. Oh, can I just go up here? Where to? It doesn't seem like there's anything up there. Oh man, maybe they just paid Charles Martinet on Cameo to do his voice for it.
That'd be genius.
Oh, this is just to help with the 100 coin challenge. I don't care about that. Even though I've got a lot of coins.
Oh, that's skeleton. Can you like punch those lanterns or something?
Yeah. Come on, turn. No, it doesn't seem. There's something there though. There's a big pirate door.
Ooh.
Oh shit!
Jump.
Oh, I was trying to. Oh, where the fuck am I now?
Have you been down there?
Yeah, I think this is that's the beginning of the level down there. Yeah. Okay, I know. Lying in bed the past couple days, I've downloaded a shitload of 3D platformers. Just to have, like, all of them of it. Oh, come on, why is this so hard now?
Like,
there's so many weird, bad-looking ones.
Like, especially this era?
Yeah, this era into PS2.
Yeah, the Million Mario 64 clone era.
Yeah.
Where everything was a Mario 64. Like.
It's true. It's exactly
0 degrees right now.
Oh, wow.
Besides the trial.
Gorgeous day.
Winger.
Hate this. I just need to get to that. Fuck! Whoa! There's a lot more stuff that you bump into in this game than you would in a Nintendo.
You
want to
do a triple jump for that.
Oh, yeah. I did a save state, so I'll... The problem is the camera freaking out while I'm doing this.
Or you might be able to... Oh, perfect.
There we go. I did not know there was nothing down below. There's that treasure room, though.
Ooh.
There seems like there should be a star in a treasure room. Shit.
Griffin says, F these coins, says Alex.
F these coins. Oh, yeah. F them in the A.
So brazen.
So this rock. Is totally the painting we can go into, punk for rock. Sure. Oh, damn.
What?
Yeah, rip off.
It's the same sunset.
Oh, yeah. Wow, this boat. I don't understand how this boat is lined up.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, easy. Right through. What a chump. If I'd gone for those blue coins, actually, I could easily have had the 100 coin star by now.
Yeah. And I think it doesn't kick you out of the level either.
Oh, it doesn't?
No. Actually, even in Mario 64, I don't think it did.
Interesting. Fuck.
And I guess in his Super Mario Odyssey emulator, it doesn't kick you back for a power move.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah, that's really good. Because you get those way faster. Like a way faster rate.
Yeah, it's true. Oh, I hate this floor,
that's
too.
That's tricky.
Wait. Why didn't I just see in the options? Oh, they did have... There we go.
Oh.
But now I've been playing with it on for so long that it's going to be so hard to get used to. No, it's easier right off the bat. Okay, good. Let's just finish exploring this room.
Yeah, it does. There's more precise platforming for sure.
Yeah, totally. The camera feels 1,000 times better already, though. maybe I can take this bot. Where'd that skeleton end up going? Oh, I thought I would restart. Thought I would restart the timer. I think I have to go up this barrel tower.
Yeah, that's tricky.
Oh fuck.
Yeah, and yeah, it's brutal that you're high enough up the. Wow, it didn't seem that far away.
Yeah. Oh, that was close.
Nice.
I mean, I save stated, but that's fine. I'm not doing this to get brownie points. Oh, there's a star in there.
Hey.
Ba, 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 ba.
Here we go.
When do I get a Pokemon?
I don't know. We explored the wreck.
I sure did. This is still nothing. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, and then another one.
Yeah.
They come a little further out each time I beat a level.
That's cool.
Can I afford anything yet?
Is it? That's the Pink Panther.
It is the Pink Panther. Everything is 5. Okay. Or 3.
Oh,
I can get the cannon opened for 3. So once I get one more star.
That's how you get your Pokemon.
I can get the cannon. All right, flipping the tiles. I like this level a lot more than I like the pirate level.
Yeah, that pirate level is just a bit too much of a maze.
Yeah.
And too, like, closed in.
Like this one, I already know if I don't feel like doing the tiles one, I could just spend my time figuring out how to catch that bird.
Yeah.
And that would be just as fun.
You were so close to the red coins in the...
Oh, yeah.
Shit.
That's true, too. And the 100 coins. Like, I could have had multiples. Yeah. Dang. Anything else up here? No, I can't make that jump. So this is how they don't have
corner jumps. Jumping, but I don't think you can wall jump up there either. Wall jumping was always tough in 64.
Mario 64. Yeah. Ah! I don't know how to do it. I'm not even bothered.
You kind of have to like bat hit the wall like that, like you were.
Yeah.
But, like it's not, yeah. Oh!
Wow! Cirque du Soleil, Mario.
Wow, yeah. He's got skills.
All right, let's get this. This camera's just freaking out. Let's get this coin. Nice. What's down?
Oh, is it a sewer?
Ah, ancient Aztec sewers are my hobby.
Whoa.
Yeah. Did it make a weird, like, dun, dun, whoa. Oh, shit.
That's awesome.
Woo! Oh, no. Oh. Oh, oh no! Oh, it's an instant kill. Okay, that makes sense. Okay, cool. I can do that.
That's cool.
I'll just make a save state before I jump in.
Oh, it just starts you here.
Oh wow!
That's so nice.
That didn't even register. Ah, oh, dumbass.
You just want to long jump everywhere.
Yeah, why wouldn't you?
Because of that. Because you don't.
Long jumping is the equivalent of holding the run button. Ooh. Down. Oh, that's it. Nice.
Here we go.
I think when I died there, the boulder rolled past. And I didn't have to deal with it anymore in the second half. Yeah, open that cannon for me, friend.
Yeah.
Wait, did you do
nice.
It?
Nice, and it keeps your stars. I mean, you keep your... You
oh,
your
yeah. Sweet.
So I wonder if you'd be able to, like, unlock all of them at level 5, then. At 5.
But what?
Must be some secret thing. Oh.
Oh. That's too low. Way too low. Okay. Mario swimming is very bad in Mario 64.
Yeah.
But I always did appreciate that you could heal yourself fully in these games by just swimming for a second and then unswimming.
Yeah. Yeah, like your air is your health.
Yeah. Okay. So I just have to shoot way above that star.
Whoa.
Nope, way too far.
You shot way above it.
I did shoot way above it. I did what I said.
Yep.
I just clearly didn't know.
It was fun.
It was a blast. That guy still creeps me out.
Yeah. He looks like somebody from Crash Bandicoot or something.
Yeah, totally. What the? Why is this shore so slippery?
Yeah.
What, I can't climb palm trees?
What? Too thick.
Too thick. No such thing as something too thick to climb. What's up here? Thought you'd have an easy retirement on your private island? Tough luck!
Oh.
I sold the rights to all your adventures and now your mansion is locked! Looks like you may have to go on some new adventures.
Oh, man.
So this is Mario's island home?
Yeah. Where the Pink Panther works.
I mean, I would hire the Pink Panther if I could, too.
Pretty cool. Oh! Close.
Oops. Too low. Oh! Oh,
yeah.
Oh, okay. Perfect. I'm so good at this. Oh, I thought I picked it up already.
Here we go.
Yes. I don't see anything else around. I must have to go into the level to get more stars.
It's always some secret stuff.
Yeah. Oh yeah, there's gotta be. Weird, my health carried over from last level into this one.
Yeah.
Not very Mario-like. flipping the tiles.
Yeah, I haven't seen any tiles.
Me neither.
Flip.
Oh, oh, oh. Cool. Meant to do that.
Red coin down there.
For sure on purpose. Oh, shit. Ah! This is a
back
really of a spot.
Uh-huh, yeah. Seems I'm not able to make it.
Is there anywhere I can... Do I fall out or do I swim?
Oh.
I fall out.
Oh.
Ah.
Yeah, you get, like, can't seem to grab the edge. Oh,
there we go.
Nice. You can.
You just had to doubt me.
Perfect.
That's what fuels me? The haters. I don't know why I'm getting the coins. I don't like that jump.
Nice.
Yeah, I didn't really expect to make that. I still see no tiles. This is where I went the first time, right? Got it.
Yeah, climbing the tower.
Yeah, oh, but I can't get across there. I see. Bird.
Bird.
The word. I'm gonna eat that bird for supper. I've almost got all of those. Oh, that's probably flipping the tiles, that big button. This level's music doesn't sound as Mario-y's.
Yeah. Yeah, it doesn't sound like it comes from a Mario game, at least.
No. Like, I should just go get the last red coin at this point.
Yeah, totally.
You know where? It's just over here, I think.
Yahoo!
No!
Ooh.
I thought it was just over here. Oh.
That's how you get the bird for sure, is that wing cap there.
Oh, the wing cap? And they just fly into the bird?
Oh, maybe not.
Jeez, he just flew right over my head. I could have backflipped into him.
Close.
Okay. Yahoo! That red coin's gotta be somewhere around here. Like, I could just launch at that bird too from here. There's too many options. There's that star. All right, let's do this bird. That's not the spot. Is it this corner that's the spot? I don't quite think so.
That one with the hat.
Yeah, okay.
But even then, I don't know, you might want to jump from the top level.
Oh, yeah, maybe. I wonder if I should just go to there.
Yeah.
Or push.
Oh, there's a star over there.
There's a star there, and where's that button? Oh, no, that's not the red coin, never mind. There's a button somewhere. It's gotta be just expertly hidden. I don't know where that switch is anymore. Can I do anything to you? Doesn't seem like it. I mean, Moais are praised for their hearty tendencies. Did I just imagine there was a button I saw?
I don't know what kind of button.
It was like purple and had an exclamation point on it.
I don't recall it.
Wow.
Yeah.
I shouldn't be able to imagine things like that. But now I've been around this thing twice.
Too many surgery drugs.
That's the thing. My brain is full of heroin and things like that. All right, let's go down. That's what I meant. There it is. Aha! Maybe this will show me where the red coin is, or it'll flip a tile. What? That's a tricky...
But there's no reason for that, is there?
There must be more stairs created up top. I'm just going to wait for this to time out. Yeah. So this is even a tricky jump to start it.
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
This brings you back up. Oh, yeah. Oh, there you go.
Okay. Okay. All right. Nope. Ooh. All right. That's a... Yeah, not a joke jump right off the bat.
Yeah. Yep. You made it look easy the first time.
I sure did. Oh, no. All right. Restart that whole roll because I accidentally pushed the wrong buttons.
Yep, that's... That's the problem with ROMs and emulators. So easy to do.
I think using save states disabled the achievements, actually. Because I didn't get any achievements on the second level. Yeah. Ah! I cannot! I was on! Ah! Oh. Oh! I dumb shit it up.
Oh,
I cannot time it. Cause it's a long one, yeah. I have to get to the absolute edge. Oh, man. It's just mean. Oh!
Oh! Did you know that in Japan, letting a sumo wrestler make your baby cry is considered good luck?
It should be good luck, so that makes sense.
Yeah, that's pretty sweet life for a sumo wrestler. You just make babies cry whenever you want.
Absolutely, I'd become that would be enough to make me want to be a sumo wrestler.
Absolutely. You'll get that opportunity very often.
And when I do, people get all angry.
Yeah, exactly. So, yeah.
Yeah.
Here we go.
I flipped those tiles. Is that what that one was? No. There's the scary box there.
That was scary.
It was, absolutely. All right, Pink Panther. I have 5 stars now. Unlock Staryu or Weeze. I'm assuming this is going to spend them, so I don't know who I want.
Oh, those guys
Gyarados
are 7.
Is probably...
Or something.
Which one's 7?
Oh, wait, never mind.
This is just the worst font line ever.
Yeah, they melded together near the bottom for me, but...
Oh, I also only have 2 stars, because it doesn't detract from my main one, but it does on the money one.
There you go.
Oh, brutal. Okay. Alright, I gotta do more levels.
Yeah, how many stars do you have? Oh, is the third one open?
Two. I have to get 3 more stars to get a Pokemon.
Sweet. I think you can do it.
That's my objective for today.
Yeah, for sure. I want to see it. Yeah.
What the fuck is a Pokemon going to do?
Yeah, it's going to give you like powers, like extra jumps or something. I don't know.
See if there's... See, that red coin's got to be around here somewhere.
I guess it's those Pokemon instead of power-ups.
Right. Oh, that's too high. Where's that red coin?
Yeah.
I'll just keep my eyes open for it.
There's gotta be a star on that golden thing, that golden platform over there.
Which one?
Over there.
That one?
Yeah.
Yeah, I agree. I agree. I'm gonna just check out this bird really quick.
Wow, goats have rectangular pupils.
That's terrifying. No wonder people associate goats with the devil.
They're probably robots.
Oh yeah, that could be too.
All right. Okay. All right,
I've got a save state.
Already took over the world. Oh, nice.
Oh, fuck yeah.
Bird up.
This game actually does have very good achievements. I birded up.
I wonder what you did for that one.
I don't know. Caught the bird with a jump instead of the cat, maybe?
Yeah,
who knows?
Yeah.
Oh, another one is coming up, I saw.
I was going to say, well, what's the third level might be up by now.
Yeah, you're right. Oops. Oh, shit. Let's go check. Sure looks like it's up. Yeah, is the fourth up too?
Yeah.
Oh wow. Killing it. Let's go somewhere else in time in history. Like Babylon. I love that place.
Babylon. Yeah, it's the Hanging Gardens.
Famous for its checkerboards. Are you a good guy?
Beautiful.
Oops, what'd you say? I'm growing a giant stalk at the top of this temple, but it's been invested. Invested by piranhas? Oh, that's the thing. You can't build a big tower without sizable investments.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Sometimes you have to side with piranhas.
That's the thing. If you want to follow your dreams. Yeah. Oh, wow. There, I did a wall jump somehow.
Yeah.
Great camera here.
This for some reason reminds me of Ape Escape.
Oh yeah, totally. What's this thing at the top?
Level design.
Yeah, it really does. Actually,
this funky statue.
It's got a tie. Is it Donkey Kong?
It's gonna be Donkey Kong.
I need to get a better angle at this Kong. How do I? Nope. Not gonna happen. Yeah, we don't get to see that. Sorry.
Cool. I gotta look at him. I think he's holding a barrel. Look at that graffiti.
Oh yeah, of Yoshi's.
Mario World.
This is a beautiful level.
Yeah, it's like the Hanging Gardens.
Star Fountain, like in Princess Zelda's castle in Ocarina of Time.
One of the seven wonders of the ancient world.
Oh yeah, that's one thing we haven't talked about Zelda at all.
They're not totally sure if they exist. If the
Hanging Gardens or all of the Seven Wonders.
If the Hanging Gardens existed,
right?
Some of them, I think, the pyramids are still there. That's one.
But did the Colossus at Rhodes exist?
Man, I don't know. That would
that would be fucking mind blowing. Yeah. That's the one I think I'd want to see. I don't think I can even name all of them. Like, the Great Pyramid is still there.
Yeah, exactly.
Is it the only one?
I don't know. I can't remember. Yeah. I think so. The Hangar of Babylon.
These piranha investors.
Temple of Artemis. Yep, that one was destroyed. Statue of Zeus. Is destroyed.
Huh.
That one's so biased.
Which one?
The statue of the Zeus at Olympia.
What's so biased about it?
It's not that great. It's just
a big statue.
It's like...
The Colossus at Rhodes is just a big statue.
Yeah, but it's like, this is like... I don't know, you know that statue of like Lincoln sitting in the chair?
Oh yeah.
And it's like smaller than, or maybe about that size. I don't know.
Oh, that's disappointing.
Like, yeah, it's like not that. Like, you don't need, if you came across the world to see the ancient wonder, you'd be like, oh my god, that's disappointing.
Are the Nazca lines an ancient wonder?
No, they didn't. Like, so the seven ancient wonders were actually written by an ancient dude.
Oh, weird. So they're all local Herodotus, to an area.
The famous Greek historian.
Yeah. He's in Assassin's Creed Origins. He's a big character.
Oh, there you go.
Yeah.
Or the other one, the Greek one.
Oh, yeah, Odyssey. Yeah.
Yeah, so that was him. He, I guess his writings didn't survive, but he planted seeds for what these were like. Yeah, Great Pyramid is the only one that's still standing.
I hate this fucking plant.
Four destroyed by earthquakes, two by fire, and one still standing.
That's the pyramids is the only one?
Yeah.
Oh, I killed all the piranha investors.
That Balam is going to not be very unhappy.
Oh, it's true. He's going to have to stop construction on his tower immediately. Here we go!
The Lighthouse of Alexandria.
Oh, yeah. Hey. And the Library of Alexandria isn't?
No.
Interesting. Interesting.
It was destroyed by an earthquake. It looks really cool. Like, it was a very different looking kind of lighthouse. Looks like giant furnace.
There we go. Speaking of the Great Pyramid of Giza,
Hey. Here
we are in Egypt.
Whoa.
Whoa. Instant what? Death in the first person.
Went like first person. Weird.
Weird. Alright. I only need one more star to buy a Pokemon. Whoa! Mummy Thwomps!
Wow, legends say that the light, because it uses a curved mirror to reflect sunlight during the day and fire at night. It's said that mariners can see the light up to 35 miles away. And legends have it, the light was so bright it could be used to burn enemy ships.
Wow. That legend has it.
That's legend. That lighthouse was so famous in ancient times that the island on which it stood, Pharos, became the root word for lighthouse in many languages.
Interesting. Wow, this tent is so fun to navigate inside of.
Yeah, it says it was real.
Huh. Alright, we're going to this hole.
They say, though, it was probably not straddling the harbor, like...
Right.
It's always shown to be.
Well, because most lighthouses are off in the distance because it's...
No, they cross the roads.
Oh, I see. Oh, that's disappointing.
Yeah, exactly. They say it was probably just, like, beside the harbor.
But it was still fucking huge?
Yeah.
That's good.
But man, yeah, like to have to go under its legs to just go in, it'd be so intimidating.
It would be really crazy. It's a big, confusing level. What are you? Ah! This level has sand hippos.
Wow.
Just like Egypt. I saw Cleopatra and some toads, but I fell trying to get to them.
Oh, damn. Oh, yeah, there they are,
cool.
Yeah.
Look at those cool.
They're fanning her.
Oh, they're slave toads.
Nice.
What's up, Cleo?
Oh. Oh, Seventh.
Weird. Seventh! I want you to investigate. Go check and solve the mystery of the tomb to the east.
Oh.
Good thing they put in that compass in that one spot on the level.
Oh, yeah. This is cool too. So the statue was toppled by an earthquake, and it snapped at the knees and fell over onto the land.
And the Colossus at Rhodes did.
Yeah.
Holy shit.
And it was just there. It was just left on the ground until like for 300 years.
Huh.
And people would still come to see it, basically, just to see it on the ground.
These guys are also giving me Super Mario Land vibes.
Yeah, totally.
Some good shit. Alright, the tomb to the east is this way. Can I take the sand boat? Ah. All right.
Yeah, significant controversy over whether the gardens existed at all.
Like, what does hanging gardens even mean?
They were just, like, beautiful, like, everything was covered in gardens.
How do I get this without dying? That's how you do
it. Some research suggests it was an elaborate series of rooftop gardens. Another theory suggests the gardens were built in the walls.
Oh, that would be pretty fucking cool. Babylon sounds pretty nice, other than a lot of their habits. Here we go. All right, let's go catch a Pokemon.
Yeah.
If I catch a Pokemon, I mean buy a Pokemon from the breeder. Yeah,
Temple of Artemis. Oh, and Mausoleum at Halicarnassus was the last one.
Oh, the Temple of Artemis is in Assassin's Creed as well.
Oh.
Yeah. All right. Do we have any opinions on who I should buy?
I lean
towards Hypno because Hypno is one of my favorites.
Who's Hypno?
He's an evolved Drowsy. Drowsy's better than Hypno, but...
Alright, yeah, go for it.
Otherwise, I can't even read... Oh, that's Onix.
Primeape isn't bad.
Primeape's pretty good. And Gyarados is always overpowered. Let's do a Primeape. They're weird and funny. There we go. We bought a Pokemon. Is this even legal?
We can come up with L.
Seismic toss and throw you far up.
Sweet. Sweet.
Interesting.
He's like one of those robot things.
And I can just summon him wherever.
Hey, Games Ideas Maker. Yeah, this is a really cool hack.
Interesting. So that's just in there to make getting some stars a little easier, I guess.
It was made by Kaze.
I think only one more star and I should have the... Wow, I got to the fifth star on that one.
Yeah, Alex, the other Pokemon. But yeah, Alex agrees, Hypno is okay, not as fun as Drowsy.
Drowsy's way better. Drowsy is my top guy. Oh wait, we should go east to the tomb, because we know Cleopatra wants me to solve it. I really like these mummy thwomps.
The mummy what?
There's mummy thwomps.
Oh yeah, those are in Mario 64.
Are they?
Yeah, on the Egypt level.
On the desert? Oh, that makes sense. Whoa.
Wow, those hippos are weird.
They're so sand and skin colored. Oh, here we go. Oh, there's Mario related hieroglyphs.
Ooh, that's all the code.
Follow the shroom to find the next room. Oh, hell yeah.
past it.
There. Oh, wow.
Whoa.
Oh, there we go. Okay, cool. Oh, it's just gonna be a series of puzzles to get through this? That's cool. Think outside the box using your hops. Let's see. Not that.
You jump up, triple jump off of it into the wall. Oh, you push it.
To where? Think outside the box using your hops.
Yeah, that might be up there. Oh, never mind. I thought it was like going through that wall.
I wonder if I just have to find the wall to push my box into.
Oh, but now.
Now I'm stuck in a corner. How do I even reset this? I'm sure I've soft locked this puzzle. I guess we have to exit this.
Yeah, we can come back. Oh, yeah, we can.
Oh, no. Oh, no.
Maybe now it's reset? Yeah.
Nope.
Oh, yeah, nope.
Maybe there's another door I can walk through? Like, maybe this pipe is a way out? No. So, like, you can see a thing above this one.
Yeah. I felt like you should have got it, though. Maybe you can triple jump up there?
Oh! Nope. The top is, right above. But that might just be the edge of the sticker they used, or whatever, to... Yeah.
Maybe it does have to do with breaking the box somehow, then. Outside of the box with your hops.
Indeed. I can always just. No, I can't even exit the. What? Reset the app. I don't think I could have pushed that box through this tunnel, right?
The next level is called Colossus of Donkey Kong.
Oh, that's so good.
Colossus of Rhodes. We were just talking about that.
Dang.
Let's see.
I might have to just reset. I don't know what the name of this level is that we're on, even.
Whoa. That's cool.
Some cool shit going on.
The enemies from, like, Yoshi's Island.
Oh, weird. Was what?
Like the right tomb?
This is the east tomb. I don't know. I'm pretty sure. It was just a hole in the ground I found. And fell into and got stuck in. And I can't kill myself. Oh, wait. I did forget I've got a Pokemon. I don't think that helps.
Oh, wow. Okay, that's tricky as hell. Actually, the Pokemon will help you here. Go back to the
the big room.
I don't know how you even figured that out. But go.
Uh-oh.
Oh, it hurts you.
Yeah.
There's like a ledge above the box, I think.
Where I put the box?
Yeah,
just all the way around.
You can see it in like first person. From far away.
I don't see it, but I'll try.
I think I just saw it there out of the corner.
Oh. Oh, I'm dead. What do you mean, huh?
Yeah, right, the guy did again. Like a crazy triple jump off the box and then wall jumped off of the wall and and got up there.
Wow, that sounds tricky.
Yeah, I was like, holy shit.
Let's go, Mario.
Let's
follow the mushroom home. Did he go into that corner that I was in?
Yeah. But
what?
Yeah.
Ridiculous.
I think so.
But I wonder if he just does that because he can use the corner to jump. Oh, yeah. I saw it. Yeah. Yeah. That makes sense.
Yeah. It's like, yeah. I don't know how you do this.
Damn it. Oh, no. Okay, so I want to use him right here.
More level after that. It's called Tiki Island.
Ooh, that sounds fun.
Ooh, the Great Wall after that.
Oh, wow.
That's cool. That looks fun. It's almost more of like a linear level.
Interesting. I need to... I can do it, but I need to push the crate not quite against the wall. Okay, I need to die so I can come back here.
Oh, weird. There's a Pokemon you lay down that's like a bomb. Like a bomb bomb.
Oh, weird. That's cool. It's a neat concept. Pretty weird and dumb, but I'm into it.
Yeah, totally. Twenty 20,000 miles under the sea.
Oh, weird. So there's a bunch.
Actually, it looks pretty. Oh, that looks cool. Actually, you get like a diving bell.
Oh, weird.
Like a hat that's just a diving bell.
That's crazy.
And it's like more like Arctic water. It looks like.
Dun dun dun.
You did it.
Ouch.
And then the Olympics? Or no.
Oh, that sounds great.
Mount Olympia, I think. Yeah. Or it just says the Olymp.
The Olymp?
That's actually, yeah, that's what it's called, the Olymp.
Start counting sheep and it's yours to keep.
It looks like you just are jumping through the world of the gods, the Greek gods. It's in the sky. Then there's Planet Namek and Waluigi.
Huh.
Yeah, that's just an alien planet. Weird.
It says start counting sheep and it's yours to keep. If I leave Mario idle long enough, is one of his animations sleeping?
Yeah, I think it is.
I wonder if that's how I do this. Is he ever gonna?
The next one's called Dandy World, my favorite historical location. Wow, it looks nuts. There's Alice in Wonderland.
Yeah!
That's a good puzzle.
It's a good star. Uh-oh, what the fuck's coming? Why did a cloud just come through?
I don't know what the hell Dandelion is. If you can go to level 5, I'd have seen one star of that, but if not, which is such a dead space.
Oh, nope. Damn. I will save my game, though, because this is fun.
Is that the next one? What the fuck? Dandelion looks insane.
Oh, man.
It's like Alice in Wonderland. It's like a giant walking centipede. Giant walking wiggler with long legs.
Oh, wow. You're making me dreaming of dead Dandelions.
It looks messed up.
Is Dandelion the next level?
No, it's the last level.
Oh, yeah, I have a while to go before Dandelion.
Then there's Pokemon Challenges and a Mario and Wario lawsuit.
What?
There's like a whole court case. It's like a...
Oh, golly.
Ace Attorney type thing. Whoa, it's like Aladdin.
It's the Cave of Truth or whatever.
Cave of Wonders.
Cave of Wonders, what's this?
No, the next one
is... Toad Mummy! Holy smokes!
Oh, that's awesome! I saw those in the video, yeah. I didn't know what they were.
Toads!
Didn't tell they were toads, that's really cool.
This level is called Cracking the Oasis.
Hey, Bruno! Bruno Bram!
Oh, what?
How's it going? Yeah, the next level is the Colossus of Donkey Kong. That's why I want to see it.
Do want to see that very badly.
And then Great Wall looks awesome.
I mean, I'm definitely not ruling out coming back to this.
Planet Namek looks very cool.
Getting weird.
There's Pokemon in this game, Bruno Bram. In this hack.
Yeah. Look, my Primeape. I'm not using him much because he definitely is not helpful right now.
Yeah, he hurts him more than else.
I wonder if I could go and change partners and try out the other Pokemon.
Oh, yeah.
Or if I have to, or if I have to have the money to buy them each time.
Yeah.
Well, hell yeah.
Here we go now.
Maybe this will get us access to that.
Yeah,
Colossus
I think so. It seemed like it was so close.
Yeah.
Yeah,
yep, we're good. Let me just go try to change your Pokemon. From the
eventually,
Panther.
There's like Pokemon challenges.
Crazy.
Yeah, there's like levels with the specific Pokemon. Oh, crazy. So.
No, I only have Primeape. Okay.
What's his name? Haunter or whatever?
Yeah, or Ghastly or one of the ghosts.
Yeah, he like makes you see like invisible for a second.
Oh, that's cool.
And you can, like, go through certain walls. Whoa.
Whoa.
Oh, it's the Donkey Kong. The Colossus of Donkey Kong.
No, he's not. He's got a big barrel. That's great.
Can you ride that jet ski?
Oh, you know it. I hope.
Might control, like, a turtle shell. Yeah. Or totally different than a turtle shell.
Don't. Oh, okay. No, it's easy. Okay, cool.
That's great.
This is great.
The Colossus of Donkey Kong. Whoa, there's a whole Donkey Kong level over there.
What?
Like a remake of Donkey Kong.
Oh, yeah. Oh, hilarious. Pretty good. It's a pretty clever game.
Yeah, that's cool. Oh wow, Onyx gives you like a platform basically. He like you can like cross Onyx.
Don't cross Onyx.
You can use it as like a bridge.
These ladders don't work.
The Pokemon challenges look hard.
Add some expert role, expert gameplay stuff.
Yeah.
Oh, this gets trickier. This is pretty good. Clever stuff.
like Donkey Kong. Whoa, wow, nice.
Some tricky jumps. Oh no, my headphone died. Oh no.
Wow.
Sacre bleu. Come on. Alright, that should fix itself now.
Yeah. Sweet.
Yeah. Be able to hear me. Yeah, it's better. They've got a fuck! No! Camera is really deadly here.
Articuno makes like an ice pillar for you to climb.
Huh.
That's weird. Oh look, there's like a star on top of Donkey Kong. The Colossus.
There's gotta be.
Yeah.
Oh, on top of the big one. No! Alright, we should play Dead Space. My spirit's been crushed.
Alright.
But I'll totally come back to this. This is great. I mean, it's Mario 64. If you don't love it, you're a dummy.
Oh, cool. The magnet guy, I think, draws coins in?
Hmm. Right, Magnemite?
Yeah.
Oh, how was I supposed to know that? Oh, rip off. Yeah, there's a lot of Pokemon in it, too. Which is hilarious.
Gyarados just seems really good for the swimming levels. And, like, just riding.
Oh, yeah, of course. Oh, that sounds great. But then, like, this thing, I think I have to use the Ski-Doo, or the Sea-Doo, rather. Alright, I just have to not crash into the frickin' boat this time. Ooh, out of my way, Koopa Troopa. Look at this Koopa Troopa, he's just standing like Jesus on top. Oh, how are you supposed to know which way to go?
Oh yeah, he loves rollerblading. I mean, jet skiing.
Or jet skiing. I think I win.
Oh, weird. What's that, the hypnotizing Pokemon?
Hypno, yeah.
He puts you to sleep, and then your health gets refilled.
Weird. Terrible. That's neat, but that's mostly useless.
Yeah. Totally. It's hilarious. They're cool. A lot of them.
What a cool game. What does Weezing do?
Let's see. I just actually got to him. Oh, you ride him. Oh, he's actually looks like maybe the best one.
I only need one more star and I can buy a new Pokemon. There's gotta be a star at the top of this Donkey Kong maze, right?
What the hell Pokemon is this one? Tangela.
Tangela? Oh, I always, yeah.
Oh, yeah, probably Tangela, yeah, for like Tangle.
Yeah.
Weird.
This is the hard part.
Shoots out vines and then like draws you into it. That one doesn't seem that useful.
Yes, questionable. The camera freaking out is the enemy here. Otherwise, this is not that hard.
You can basically use it to get like a little bit more horizontal ality.
Oh yeah, he's like, it's the horizontal version of my Primeape.
Yeah, kind of, yeah.
Interesting. So you think coughing or wheezing is the one to buy?
Yeah, he seemed really cool. All the ones I've seen so far. Like, he just flies and you ride him.
That is pretty good. I could save up for the wing. Oh, I don't have enough money anyways. I still need another star. Good stuff, though.
Totally.
Game rocks.
Stardew seems pretty great, too.
Yeah.
Just shoots like a jet of water up and you get like a jump, a big jump out of it.
How do I climb that Donkey Kong statue, I wonder?
That I don't know. You might need the wing cap. Oh, sorry. Missed some messages here.
Oh, no.
He doesn't have the 2017 T-pose. Yeah, totally, Bruno. Mario's camera really sucks. And yeah, it doesn't look like there's a Pikachu.
No, I like the Pokemon choices they put in, actually.
Yeah.
There's enough, like, not, like, super common ones.
Yeah. Alex says, I bet Hypno puts enemies to sleep then. Yeah, probably.
Oh, yeah.
It took, like, the move looked like it took a long time to land.
Oh. Coolest shit thing. Good job, guy who did it.
Yeah, Kaze. Oh,
here we go.
Whoa, that's how you get it.
Where was that? Oh, the one on the statue. Yeah. Which one do I go for first, though? This is a tough shot, I think. I think that's a long way away.
Yeah.
Like, that's not even close, like, and it was way high, above it.
Wow, even higher than that.
No, oh, I think if I can grab that. I wonder if I have to shoot onto the red rope.
Maybe.
What's happening?
I don't know what that was. Oh, so close. Just a little higher and a little more to the right.
It's auto-launching me once. Oh, because in loading, it's sometimes I'm summoning my Pokemon because it's the same button.
This is a little more to the right. Oh.
Oh. Yeah, it's got to be onto that rope, right?
Just a little higher.
Yeah. Oh. I think I'm too far right. Oh, and not high enough.
Oh, still higher, though, too.
Too far right?
Yeah.
And not high enough.
And still not high enough.
Too far and still not high enough.
Maybe, yeah. You might just catch the bottom. You went further right.
I'm not sure if I
can. It doesn't seem like, at max, you just barely make it.
That one's perfect.
Yep. Yeah.
Oh, man.
That's awesome.
That's some good shit.
No!
Oh, I hate everything. That was freaking brutal. It was stolen from me. Oh, hey. I can't get through his bicep.
Oh, no. Too slippery. No.
Oh!
You're flying.
Oh, no. All right. I don't think that's working.
All right.
Oh. Oh. Huh. I don't think I'm getting myself out of this pickle.
What's the red thing in the barrel? Is that blood, says Bruno? You mean that rope?
No, what's it supposed to represent on the barrel? Why is there a big red strand coming out of it? Oh, in case he's throwing bombs at Mario.
That's what Alex said, and that's what I saw, too. Yeah.
All right, I saved. Okay. I'm not.
Oh, now you do it perfectly.
So easy. I made it hard. All right, now I can go buy a Pokemon. I think the Weezing is the wiener. You've captured Weezing! Huh. Weird.
I think he can fly up and down too. I don't know how. But...
I made him go down there.
Yeah.
Oh, there we go. Weird.
That seems super useful and game breaking.
Oh, hey. Yes.
Whoa.
I'm stranded. Please grab my tail and drag me back into the water.
That's pretty sweet. I feel like those characters weren't in Mario 64 before.
Huh. What are they from?
From, like, Mario World.
Oh yeah, that you would ride on.
Yeah.
Wow, they look so different.
And tell all the other dolphins about this.
Oh, fuck yeah. This game is very good.
Yeah. Here we go! Dragging dolphins?
Yeah. Great. To safety.
Okay, we gotta visit Dead Space, because it's gonna work this time.
We gotta. It's gonna work.
Oops, yeah.
If it doesn't, we'll play more Mario.
Yeah, exactly. Oh, the dolphin is in the original game, says Bruno. Oh, yeah, I wasn't sure. Okay. I couldn't remember where they show up.
Where you least expect them.
But we're going to play some Dead Space 3. So stay tuned for that.
Yeah.
We're going to take a quick break, and we'll be right back.
Absolutely.
Cause silly.
Oh boy.
Look at that.
Oh no, our temperatures are dropping.
Dead Space is working. It's happening. Here we are.
It's happening. Oh no. It feels weird. Zelda has such strange controls that playing other games while playing Zelda feels crazy.
That's true. Like, yeah, run. Having to run on the base buttons.
Run with A on the base buttons?
Oh, like, yeah, I see what you did. X.
Y.
Oh, right. This is that crazy shotgun. Shot.
Yeah, I forgot what's going on.
Feels a bit overpowered, this gun, I remember.
I think we both just juiced our guns up towards the end last time.
Yeah.
We're both also... Our temperatures are dropping.
Oh. Behind you.
Guy?
Are you wearing something?
I'm just trying to stay warm. I have a helmet on. You're the one who's a crazy person with no helmet. And I do it? No. And then what's this? We must need a key card.
Let's check out what's up here.
Very cold.
Yeah. I don't know how to warm up.
I think we gotta find inside. Oh!
I got it. Oh wait, no, I got an artifact.
Oh, even better.
There's nothing up here? Oh man.
Oh! Oh shit, I'm dead.
What?
Huh.
How'd you die?
There was a guy that jumped me, and I didn't realize I was low on health, because I'm just constantly hearing health noises because of the temperature.
No.
Oh, and he chopped me to death. Okay, it looked like I was about to go inside something, though. So that's the way.
Yeah, we weren't doing great anyway.
No. Considering we started 35, and we were already down to, like, 18.
Oh.
Watch your back! Oh, it's my me he's after. Yeah, it was like over here. Although we won't get that artifact then.
Mm-hmm.
First the guy jumps out of the snow, yep. And then there's a guy as soon as you go around this corner. Going inside is the best way to get warm, in my experience.
It's toasty in here.
It's because this is the room where they go to make toast.
Wait, did I get another scavenger box?
Hell yeah. I forgot. Oh, I've got two scavenger bots. Yeah. Be sure to have your ration card stamped. Yeah, send them out. We don't want anyone going hungry out there. What a terrible mechanic. It's not letting me send out my second. Oh, there we
I
go.
I only seem to have one, but it seemed like I had just picked one up.
Oh.
Is there anything else in there?
I started an audio log, but I'm pretty sure you did that too. So no. But we got nice and toasty. Like toast.
Oh.
Watch out. He's coming. These people could make a good thing game.
Yeah.
Yeah, they got the designs down.
You got like a floaty, you got a piece of them just floating.
I'm carrying
you're telekinesis. Yeah. Okay. That's confusing. It looked like you were pointing your gun.
Where the fuck are we going? Wait. How do we check our... Wait, that's not in this game at all?
I think it is, but our... I don't know if we have it right now.
Oh. Hate that.
Oh. That's bullshit.
Behind, yeah, you're right behind
like
you.
Like at the same time. Oh!
There's never only one enemy that shows up.
Yeah.
Man, we need some temperature. Basis coding.
Sweet. He's like under the tre- he was under the treasure.
Oh,
that
devil. I hear a zombie. Oh, there he is. Oh, man. My temperature is straight up bad.
What a place to hide.
I wonder if we were supposed to have found somewhere to go inside before we got here? I don't know. Just beeping very quickly.
Dead ends everywhere. Yeah, there's like nothing in here.
Yeah, was this just like a treasure spot and we didn't get very good treasure? Oh, bloody hell. I'm gonna go back here. This... looks like a structure. Maybe we can go in it.
Somewhere. I know. Oh, shit.
How do we, Oh, I'm down. Oh, no.
Oh, no.
You're also down. Oh, no.
I'm not down.
Yes. Oh, you're not down. I'm down. And I'm
but I only have fire. It's...
Oh, I'm dead. There's just a guy coughing vomit on me from a distance.
Oh, I hate when that happens.
Yeah. Oh. Nuts. Well, now we know not to go into that icy hell.
Yeah.
I used my telekinesis in that fight.
Ooh.
Yeah. Oh, that checkpoint also, I think we were at good health coming out of it now. Or good, temperature. Oh!
Yeah,
I saw him coming. Oh, you went around this side, I went around the other side when I got
stuck. Oh! I like how they burrow in the snow.
Totally. I didn't notice that until this little...
Oh. Oh.
Is this a guy who's gonna come back to life? No. Like, our guns are cool, but they're just nowhere near as satisfying as the first game.
For
guns.
Sure. Yeah.
They, everything just melts when we shoot it.
Yeah.
Go to the staff. What do you mean you're waiting? I'm waiting at the door with you.
No, that sounds like we found the right place. Oh, no.
Oh, Frosty Pete. Frosty Pete hates being cold, ironically.
They headed for a research facility up the ridge. We found snowsuits, but they were
it's cold in here, too.
I decided to stay behind. There might be more down in the basement.
I tried to put him out of his misery.
There might be more in the basement.
Well, the elevator shot, and
Oh. Something scratching around out there. So they didn't check. So we didn't. I would. I mean, it's better than you dying. Like, if I was you, I would go check, and rather than die from freezing to death.
Moving, you're gonna keep your temperature up a little longer, even.
Yeah.
But who knows how low his temperature is already?
Yeah, he looks hurt. But, and you know,
he spent a lot of time just being scared.
Huh.
Powered up in here.
Is there like a thing I can hook onto this gear?
Yeah, there's several gears in here.
Oh, interesting.
I just launched one at you.
There we go. I think that'll do it.
Oh, you don't even need more than one?
No.
There's a bench in here if you need.
I don't know. I don't think so.
I'm just going to double check. Because yeah. I think I have some things. Oh, yeah, I had items in my inventory to drop off.
Did you have to go out to get in? Or how'd you get in there?
Yeah. Oh, sort of out around the back.
I see.
Yeah.
Oh, what is that musical sting for? That's scary.
Ooh, we started getting +2 damage circuits as well. Interesting, but they're also, they're +2 damage, but minus to other things.
Oh.
I would rather take damage than rate of fire, that's fine. Oh wow, I remember being low on things at one point last time. Just going through one combat scenario trying to use telekinesis instead of shooting, I have so much ammo again. That's the trick.
Hmm. I had one space open, so I used the one that if I heal, it heals you too.
Oh, great. That's a great one to have. I wonder, it must not heal me as much as you, because that would make the game way too easy.
Yeah, I don't know.
Oh, yeah.
It looks good to me.
I totally forgot I even had the secondary function on this gun. It seems to be just the big fart that pushes people away.
Yeah, every one of my things has damage now.
Huh.
Every one of my upgrades has some kind of damage.
Interesting. I think mine all but one, and it's because I didn't want to do a minus something damage one.
Yeah, that's the final one. I just replaced, yeah.
Yeah.
It was minus rate of fire, though.
Okay. I have a minus reload, which that might come back to bite me, but...
Alright, let's go.
I just got a text that I think was not meant for me. To let the person know that they're trying to tell someone they're somewhere, I'm not going to be able to help them.
They say Norton was right about not going
to... Who knows?
Hey, there's your face.
Oh yeah. Your gun looks like your outfit.
Yeah, matching.
Interesting.
Matchy. Yeah.
It's important.
Fashion is super important in this grim world. What are
you gonna do when everything? You have to find joy in the few things that you can control.
Exactly. You're fucking lost, Clark.
We don't seem to have the ability to skedaddle our radar. Yeah. Who knew?
Hmm.
There it's just tantalizing us. Whoa! Oh,
that's what was scratching around down here.
Where did yeah, trying to climb into a cupboard.
Mouth shut. Eyes open.
Door is that?
New type of enemy. Ooh, this is just a room full of hanging bodies.
Oh, that's a hobby.
Maybe they're not bodies. Maybe they're just bags. Maybe it's just a room full of hanging bags. Where I keep my bag collection.
Full of random meat.
Oh, yeah. Glove randomly. Oh!
They just kind of pose for us?
Yeah. They're just like, oh, I'm busted! Uh-oh. Only I didn't reload so slow. Oh, wow, that made a big difference. Wow, just a shitload of stuff. This is like shooting the babies for stuff in other Dead Space games.
Yeah, I like those guys.
They're great.
There's give us like a slow. Sweet tableau to shoot at.
Yeah. Like they were sitting in darkness, but we have those nice fancy flashlights.
Yeah.
Newfangled flashlights. They just can't handle it.
That strategy does not work.
No. What's this? Is that just a
personal log? Sam Ackerman.
Sam Ackerman.
Oh, cool name.
He's the man.
They also take like one shot to kill.
There's one sneaking around in there and I just keep shooting him in the head.
Oh, that one's speed flying. Oh yeah, I gotta get some reload speeds on this gun. Oh, he's on, they can climb on the ceilings.
Oh, hi man.
Yeah, a whole bunch just crashed in. Cool noise. Oh, wow. Shotgun makes him roll around like a crazy person.
I got a +2 damage, -1 clip. That's
better. I don't know. I like it better than reload, for sure.
But yeah, like, I have rate of fire, like actually. That might be the best one. Yeah, I don't really notice it at all.
No, because you only have to shoot, like, a couple shots to get a kill.
Yeah. I'm already, like, not holding it down or anything.
So. Alright, there was a lot of stuff to pick up after that.
Go to the pump room.
This is where they do all their nasty stuff.
Yeah, pump room.
What?
We're trying to locate like another team, I think.
Oh. I've really just paid no attention to what's going on. Oh, I got us an artifact.
Nice. We're gonna be rich.
Oh yeah, you gotta sell it. Alright, I'm covering you from up here. No, I'm not, it doesn't matter.
What's this? Oh, a puzzle.
Damn it. I'll let you smash your head into that while I explore this immediate area.
Oh, this is cool. Oh, it's a little more complicated than it looks. That's a good puzzle, actually. It's kind of cheap. Gotta be this, though, because this is the only combination that has that I haven't done.
Oh, yeah. Because only the bottom one has the 3-prong, and only the top one has the 1.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. Nice. That opens up the spike wall, too. Oh, this is gonna end poorly. See, we need to just do stasis on it like in Zelda and then smash it.
Whoa.
Oh, shit!
Oh.
Oh! The goblin ran out and blocked me from going through the door.
I think we do need to use stasis on it.
I think so. This is not how I want it. So it doesn't go far enough back this first time. Then the second time. I can see him through the side here. Oh, no, I can't make it. Oh, I think there was an artifact down there. Oh, no, there's another door down there.
Yeah, we need to go that way.
That was covering it. I'm gonna see if there's anything, like, in this as it pushes. There's not. That's a weird window they give us there.
Yeah. Oh, wow. A giant version of that same puzzle.
Oh, don't let your poison gas in there. I'm surprised they wouldn't make some enemies come here for me to have something to
do. Yeah,
it's
true, actually. I don't know. That's not it. So it's gotta be...
That's always what I want with these. We just have to locate a suit kiosk? Oh, we're having a helmet malfunction. We need a suit kiosk, I see. Puzzle solved.
On the station.
Just gotta breathe. Oh, I hear monsters. Oh. They're behind us. Yeah, they're a fun one to fight.
Yeah.
They're just kind of bumbling and dumb.
Holy smokes.
Just by the hair on my chinny chin chin. They're also good enemies because they always shriek to announce their coming.
Yeah, unless they're doing a tableau.
Sergeant Cochran, take the security key and head to Depot 212. I haven't heard a thing from Sergeant Lumpy, not since the Franklin incident last week. I'm sure I do not have to express the importance.
Medic support handgun? Oh, this is smart. The first time they've done that.
What?
Put two suit kiosks right next to each other.
Oh, really?
Yeah. So are we supposed to switch to this Arctic survival suit?
I would think so.
Disappointing. I had upgraded my other one. Or maybe the upgrades are not part of it.
Don't let your poison gas in here, says Alex Casey.
What's your point? Oh, I have a way cooler winter suit than you do.
Yeah. Wow.
Oh, man. Oh, man, my face is so cool.
Oh, yeah. Mine's good for camouflage, though.
I could afford one upgrade.
Oh, hey, this is the other side of that? Yeah. We just wanted those suits.
Needed those suits. Where's the item? I heard an item sound as I ran through. Look at my sweet red eyes.
Yeah.
That guy definitely became the bad guy. But you're just like, if Harrison Ford was wearing one of these suits.
Yeah. Well, I got camouflage, that's the thing. You're gonna stand out.
Oh, that's, yeah, but I won't accidentally get hit by any equipment.
That's not my worry.
Equipment accidents account for, like, huge amount of deaths in this world.
But I wouldn't wear my camouflage around.
That's true. It's just, sometimes it's unpredictable. So now that we're out of here, do we go to that ice area? Or what? I guess whatever this is. High wind area.
Oh no. Oh,
someone's blowing smoke.
Oh no. The greatest enemy of all.
Yep.
Let your poison gas in here.
Like old man Winter. I got a Tesla core. Make our guns electric.
Nice. Oh yeah, we've been just frozen without these suits.
That should have blown. The thing is, now I'm gonna lose you because you're camouflage.
That's right.
Just so I stick out.
I'm gonna lose myself.
Oh,
hey, it's Breath of the Wild.
Oh yeah, totally. This game's just like Breath of the Wild.
Some sweet mountain climbing.
Yep.
Oh. Whoa, it's the team. And they've got glowing red eyes. And yellow eyes.
He didn't give us tra- oh, he didn't. There aren't enough xenomorphs in Breath of the Wild.
Absolutely. I'm sorry. I just left that to you. Uh-oh. I didn't know this was... I thought this was going to be the wrong way.
Oh, no. You went the right way?
Oh, no. Maybe not. It just...
I'm in just a room full of treasures.
Just made it seem like this thing was going to fall.
So I'd say you went the wrong way because you're not getting all this stuff I'm getting. Oh, yeah. You went the right way.
Oh, okay.
Down here, there is nothing else. I'm... full up on inventory.
Oh!
Oh. What triggered that?
You're walking
over here.
In here.
Oh shit! I wasn't paying attention. Not ready for a quick time event.
Oh, nice one, Isaac. Whoa.
Oh, man. Seems like a bass in
like Uncharted.
Yeah, I was gonna say, it's like the first level of Uncharted 2. But way less.
Whoa. Good jumping.
Our guys are so creepy. Stepping next time.
Rickety piece of shit. Rickety shit. That's
gotta
be it. Oh, shit. Lit up like it's fucking Christmas. Oh, it's getting nice again.
Ellie, I told you she made it. Come on.
So are we supposed to be moving with urgency right now? We
yeah,
must be.
The team might be dead. Oh, God. Moon trap.
Yeah. God. I don't know, I didn't get God actually. I veered off at a certain point. Oh, where the hell am I?
Keep it down.
This feels like a boss arena.
Wall, it's pretty.
We're sitting ducks. She's in there.
Whoa.
We're not getting in through the front door.
Have we not seen that yet?
Seen what?
That giant glowing thing on this planet. Like, we've been on this planet for a while.
Oh, yeah, it's true.
Have we not seen that?
That's well hit. can't do that. Oh, that one. Hey, what? There's definitely a boss.
Let's get one thing straight, Clark. We came to this frozen shithole to stop the markers, and nothing, not you or your obsession with Ellie, is gonna get in my way. You got that? I know I'm doing this.
Business.
Why they call me Carver or whatever.
Let's get this lift powered up. With any luck, everyone will be waiting for us past the gates.
Oh, we can go back to our old suits.
Oh, I like my suit.
I'll go back to my old one.
Your old one was nicer than mine.
Yeah.
There's like the build guns from Blueprints here. I don't remember ever looking at it. There's some dumb named guns. The Intimidator, the And Tubes, Sweep the Leg, the Disemboweler, the Infected Dissolver. That's pretty exciting. Oh, and Mjolnir. That's gotta be strong. I have an inventory absolutely full of shit right now.
Yeah. It's weird because my suit has a helmet in the pictures. Oh, there we go. I put it on.
You just don't want to wear it. Who needs a suit helmet?
Nope. Oh, crazy. I have a lot of upgrades for this suit already.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I think it goes across all your suits, your upgrades there.
Oh. Yeah. Oh, no, well, this is my old suit.
Oh, yeah, there you go.
So the only thing I can even upgrade is stasis. Or air. I can upgrade my air. There we go.
I didn't have enough tungsten to do anything when I looked last.
Yeah, me neither.
It's hard to come by tungsten in this world.
Yeah, now I have two. Oops, shit.
Move out of the way. Let me see if I can upgrade. I just got a bunch of tungsten, I think. Can't upgrade my hit points. Can't upgrade my armor. Poof, perfect. Everything else, I don't think it matters if I upgrade my stasis. Nice. I just set my two guys out. Your guys will definitely find stuff over here. Where's this boss gonna trigger? Oh wait, elevator.
Yeah, it's a huge open area.
Waiting for partner.
Where did he come from? Wow.
The sky. He's a sky.
And he's just like pushing us around. Wow. Big spider.
It's true.
Oh, shit.
Each leg is twice as good.
Oh, come on.
Wow, your shots just knocked his thing off so easily.
He's good for it. Wow. That was awesome. I shot at my shotgun and just fell right in front of me. Oh, that time.
Yeah. know. Run off into the darkness.
Hey, I'm not finished with you yet. Where's it going?
On it.
Where it always goes?
That's just it?
There, somewhere.
Out there.
Come on.
Somewhere.
Somewhere.
Somewhere out there. Beneath the pale blue sky.
That's what the song was written about.
That's what that guy, yeah, he's, if we could see him right now, that's what he'd be singing.
Ellie? Are you there?
Not this again.
Ellie.
Not this again.
Isaac. Oh my god, he's alive?
They're like a comedic duo.
Hey, Captain.
Oh, Ellie. They are.
Oh, so good to start that again.
How did you make it? The ship, we thought you were dead.
Oh, brother.
Flares. Are you guys all right?
Yeah. Yeah, for the most part. I can't believe you're both alive.
What?
Oh, what?
Yeah.
It just popped up on my screen waiting for co-op partner to swap discs.
Oh, weird. I just got a thing that said, please wait.
Crazy. I'm glad you didn't have to swap discs.
Yeah.
It seems to have taken care of itself.
But this ladder.
I think this ladder is where we want to look first.
Pulse rifle.
That sounds fun. Not even an artifact?
What?
Oh, you got an artifact. Oh, thank goodness. I like my red suit because I have a green gun. Now I feel like I'm a Christmas-themed guy.
It's fun.
Yeah.
One of Santa's helpers.
Oh.
Santa hates the necromorphs, too.
Well, because the necromorphs hate kids, and Santa loves kids.
Exactly.
So it's...
kids has to deal with Santa. Mercenary.
He's a hardcore dude. Oh, I get to hack. This is the first time I've hacked in this game.
Hey, lucky. This also feels like a place a boss is gonna try to kill us.
Really does.
Oh, what's that? Oh, this is where we're supposed to go.
Okay, I've found somewhere we're not supposed to go just yet. But it doesn't seem to have much of interest in it either. Oh, wait, a door that I need you for.
Oh,
yeah. Interesting. So I don't know where we're supposed to go.
Interesting. Oh, jeez.
My shotgun's awesome because it lights them on fire.
That is great.
Yeah. Very satisfying.
Holy shit, I was close to dying.
Ooh.
I didn't even notice.
I die because I don't pay attention to my health more than anything.
Yeah.
I have so many medkits.
Hey, Cyrus Black, how's it going?
What's up, Cyrus?
Good to see ya.
How do you feel about Dead Space 3, Cyrus?
Dead in space.
Just more dead people in space.
Interesting. I don't know what that other area. Oh wait, this still looks, seems like a dead end.
Oh yeah, that's true.
Because the other area seems very much like a place we're supposed to go.
Right. Yeah. I think we're good. I don't know where that boss fight's at though.
Yeah, where that thing scuttled off to.
Here, yeah.
Oh, it's in here. I didn't notice.
Hell yeah. Extra treasure that we definitely need.
You see this thing? It's like, oh yeah.
Oh yeah, this looks very official. Alright. cutscene.
Oh, hey.
People, humans.
Other people.
It's Ellie and the guy in the blue coat.
Cyrus is savagely ambivalent.
Oh, wow.
That's the way to live.
Good to see you made it, Isaac. Yeah, maybe we should give you two some time.
Throated
alone, huh?
Passion.
What the hell does that
or
mean?
It means for someone who's in the past, nah. You're awfully glad
to see him. Not caring.
This mission needs him.
We need him or you need him.
You got something to say to me, Captain?
Stop, oh, boy.
Stop. We need to shut down that.
It is definitely the most boring of the games so far.
Yeah, I mean, the first two are better, for sure.
Oops. I wonder if it's because of it being co-op.
So, that takes some of the scariness down, but also just because of the... It's more action-y, too.
Yeah. Yeah, it's just dudes with assault rifles shooting monsters.
Yeah, exactly. It definitely, yeah, doesn't have the same feel.
One of their names is Carver. That's pretty cool. Pretty damn cool name. Oh.
Oh, Cyrus Black isn't a fan of the close-up third person, like the basically Resident Evil 4 popularized.
I mean, no one does it close to as good as RE4.
Yeah, it's
the best. But I like a few of these. I also love the concept of battle tables.
Absolutely. Yeah.
Very cool.
It just reduces everything to toys.
Yeah.
You could really forget you're
sending people
sending real humans to die.
That's true, but at least it looks fun.
Yeah, that's what I mean. It's super fun.
I'm gonna see about making myself a tungsten bar.
I need a torque bar.
That's what I'm seeing about making, rather. Because that's how we get in there.
Where did you go?
I think you make it in the bench somewhere. Oh. I just don't know where. Yeah, I can make a tungsten torque bar, but it costs all my tungsten.
Your body takes up too much of the screen, says Harris, to just make it first person? Yeah, that's kind of true. I get it.
I'm going into the torque bar room.
I like seeing my guy too, though.
Yeah, this one particular, like the first two Dead Space is much more than this one. It kind of mattered to be in third person because you could see your whole UI is taken care of on your character.
That's true. It's a good point.
It's a cool thing.
It's one of the most more clever aspects of these games. Yeah, is how everything. Yeah, there's no UI. It's all on you. The health stasis.
Oh, it's all on UI.
Every time you point your gun, it shows you your ammo.
Yeah.
On the gun. Even this menu, the idea is it projects out of your hand here.
It's a neat thing. But also less cool in this game than in the past two.
Yeah. But yeah, you wouldn't be able to do that with first person. Will you look? Will you talk?
I got 15 tungsten back for doing that, but it cost me 20 tungsten to get into that room.
I don't know where we are, where you went.
Oh, I left that room. I was done exploring it, and now I'm...
Sounds like it's somebody's job to make the little diorama table. Absolutely.
Oh, wow, that's... Like that, if you go, you go to Warhammer University.
Is it a full-time job? Do they have arts and crafts club?
Oh, man.
Exactly.
Wait, is this where we came from?
Yeah.
Hmm.
Yeah, and how do you get that job? How are they like, we need somebody to make little dioramas.
You just have to be the best
at Warhammer. Who's the guy? Oh, yeah, there's that guy who just makes little dioramas.
Yeah, he's perfect for our
years. He just
war.
Did it on his own, and then people were like, "Hey, you make really great little dioramas. Can you make?
What could you do with
dioramas?
A proper military budget behind you?"
Yeah, like the best so few other places that would use that.
It's true.
Like maybe a train set.
Yeah, you could design toy sets.
Oh.
sucks. We didn't end up fighting a boss in that place.
How the hell did Danik's men find us?
Come on, run!
Ali! Yeah, Zyra says you only need one of those tables per base, though. Yeah, that's the thing. Like, how? Yeah, but it's.
Oh, you have to be a true neutral party in that.
Maybe it must be made like by like a team of people. Yeah. Oh, what?
Oh, we're fighting people now.
Just humans. What's their problems?
The Danik's men. Whoever Danik was, that guy. You know, it was fun. No one. Yeah. Why has Dead Space become this at this point?
Yeah.
That's silly.
Oh.
They still drop items like zombies?
Yep. Okay, the same items.
Perfect. Heads fall off just like zombies too. Partner's waiting for me. Oh, you're in there. That seems to be the only way to go. Okay, cool.
Fire says, so is it just like one guy who travels the galaxy as an itinerant craftsman?
Oh, that, what a job.
Yeah,
what a,
I guess,
life.
So. Or maybe it's like a team of people. You've got somebody who's like a good woodworker and somebody who's good at making maps. And
by woodworker, you mean someone who can make things look accurately like wood. In these maps, like, you have to have trees, and
yeah,
you have to have...
the log houses,
yeah,
for sure.
Oh, we're definitely just gonna be fighting more people for the rest of this game.
Like a mathematician.
Oh,
to
yeah,
get the scale right. And the whole team. It's one of the hardest jobs in the military.
But, like, it's one of the best.
Yeah.
Because you don't have to kill all the people. This game feels like it's getting a little dumb right now.
Yeah, it feels like we're getting close to the end, though.
I don't know. We
just
got to disc 2, thinking. Like,
I always forget, like, we looked before, and it was super far off.
Yeah. We just got... I think we're just past half, dude.
Yeah, it's crazy. It's not the first time.
Whoa.
It felt like we were headed towards an end.
Ouch! Asshole's shooting me with his rocket gun. Oh, I'm down. I'm down. Oh, he's coming to kill me. Oh, he's coming to kill me. I'm gonna die. Ooh. Oh, there are zombies.
Oh, I almost died.
I had to use a couple health packs on myself right there. Oh, it's worth stomping these guys. The human ones make treasure after you kill them if you stomp them.
Oh my god. I annihilated that guy.
But you got his somatic gel for doing it, so. It was worth it.
Everyone all right?
Yes, I think we're safe.
We are anything but safe. They're after Isaac, and we're getting caught in the crossfire.
Look, the warehouse.
And the stasis I want to control, like magnesis.
You're not worth this.
Oh yeah. Directed suspension field. Like, that's a cool item I just got to make a gun with. Oh, one of our little dudes just returned to the base. That's fun.
Yeah, we do have a lot of new blueprints. Maybe I'll try something.
My gun is so effective.
Yeah, exactly.
But yeah, I should too. I should just put my second gun in storage. I can't put it in storage. Okay.
Oh, wow. And you just need parts to make the guns too.
Yeah, that's the thing. So upgrade or get new weapons. I'm just gonna stick
with what's
getting here.
Yeah, there's so many, and they need
a lot of stuff.
A lot of stuff. But I don't really have anything else to upgrade, really.
Like, I still want to upgrade my hit points on my suit, but that just takes tungsten.
Yeah, it's mostly there already.
Let me shoot your little dudes.
Dare.
Jerk like that.
Huh, you let them fire them.
I think it's interesting. I do like games where bad guys fight bad guys.
Yeah, absolutely. That I always feel like that should happen in Zelda more.
Oh yeah, totally. Or you should be able to set it up more easily in Zelda.
Although I do love, have you ever had a moblin pick up one of the little guys and use them as a weapon?
No.
That's hilarious. It hasn't happened to me yet on this playthrough either, but before it has.
Is there a guy chasing me? What are you shooting? Oh, whoa!
Yeah, there totally was. He was like right behind you.
That corpse just flew out of nowhere at me. I've healed a bunch of times too because I think Zelda reasons.
Oh yeah.
Like,
wow,
just...
this is pretty.
Where the devil are you?
Yeah, I can't. Is there? I don't think there is a way to like see where the other person is there?
No. Oh, but my right click stick's worked.
Oh,
and it does show
hold
where
it
you
down.
Are. Yeah. Yeah. I think we must have fixed that in our suits or something.
No, I saw a thing that said it. Like it said it. I think we were just pressing it before, and it makes you crouch. We were like, oh, that's just the crouch button.
Yeah, that's weird. Oh, I see where you found that. You said it was pretty. Oh, there you go. Okay.
Yeah. So we're good to go.
I've inevitably got. Partner's waiting. I'm looking for treasure, partner.
I think we share the stuff with him.
I think not the resources. The, oh, wow. What?
What?
There's a guy in here with us.
Yeah.
Oh, I think we just... Oh, we closed the door again. Huh.
Ooh.
Yeah, I think we only share the, like, important shit we find.
I don't know. It seems like... I had a bunch of items in that last room. Like, is there an item here for you?
Yeah. I don't know what it was, but I did pick something. This one here. And... that guy's got his screen showing. Depends upon it. Stop him at any cost. Altman be praised. Altman be praised. God, I don't know where.
Sarah says the third person's even worse in small places like the elevator. Yeah, it's true. That's always been the weird thing for sure, is how like the camera moves against the wall and it just gets like shoved into your face.
Oh yeah. Doubly so with two players too.
Yeah.
This is the only way he could have come. Be ready.
You ready to move?
Oh. Oh, I got blown up by a grenade.
Yeah, I saw that. Oh, you can throw enemy grenades? And there's B to grab and throw enemy grenades.
Fun. Will I remember to do it?
Oh, shit. Oh, that guy didn't have any. Way grosser stomping humans.
It really is. Their bones aren't all ripped apart by religious diseases. Oh, you look like you're almost dead.
Yeah, I guess I'm pretty hurt. Oh, there's so many of these doors.
And there's... Yeah, that's nothing over here. There was one box of treasure. I don't think it matters. Yeah, who thought putting a big outdoors world into this was a good idea?
Whoa. His head.
And replaced his head.
He made really quick work of that guy, yeah.
Now he's a full grown man with a baby's head.
We could have shot him a bunch of times, man.
Yeah, we could have killed him before the baby took over his head.
That's hilarious. You just keep going after other corpses.
Yeah, even if the corpses are horribly destroyed.
Yeah.
I guess my shotgun would bite you too. Oh, that big beast.
I just want to jump off here and use my parachute. Go down there.
Oh, that would be so good. You climb up the side of him.
Yeah, exactly.
Find like, a Korok seed.
Breath of the Wild just makes you want to go everywhere in games. Like, why can't I? Why am I blocked at all? Let me climb all the mountains.
What did he say?
I don't know. Oh, my God, this thing.
There we go.
Whoa.
There was a little head strolling around. I don't know where. I think we killed it.
We just slapped it.
Need a key card? Two-player puzzle, it looks like. I think we did one of these before. Mm-hmm. Yeah, you have to navigate. Oh, there's guys. He's gotten up there. We've blasted him with the shotgun 3 times.
Yeah. Powerful legs.
Right. Yeah.
Skip leg day.
Every day's leg day when you're only legs.
And tentacles.
And tentacles.
Because you gotta work out. He should have worked out his tentacles a little more.
Yeah, he skipped tentacle day all
that's,
the time.
Yeah, that's why we beat him.
Because you never skip tentacle day.
Oh, never skip that. You will regret it.
Wow, what a difficult puzzle.
Yeah, what?
What's the point of... That's just to waste time. Oh, I can't even pick that up. Okay, now we need to turn the power off. Ah, there.
Boring platform bodies. Attention, all hands. Obstruction. Please clear to resume drilling.
Help me get those safety gates down.
Safety gates down? Better know what
you're doing. Safety gates down.
You better know what you're doing.
Safety gates should be up. Oh, so you have to go to that one. The other one.
Where are
this one.
Oh, I have to go to the other side. The one that's closer to you. Oh, wait, no.
I was just pointing at that one.
I see.
There
Right? Yeah.
3, 2, 1, go.
What do we do? Oh, hold. I see.
Oh.
Ow, we're getting splashed.
Oh!
Dude!
Oh shit, I was just gonna heal.
Hey, I work on ships, not giant drills.
Yeah.
Look for an override. What the fuck is that?
Oh, you look like Dr. Doom.
I don't like my gun now that it takes forever to move up.
Oh. Fuck off! I was trying to heal. Oh, I think I'm out of healing. Oh, shit.
Oh, no. Where are you?
He just kept hitting me. Holy smoke, this is chaos.
What are we waiting for?
I don't know, the drill's doing something. I think I wasted a lot of health there because I was trying to heal and the guy kept hitting me and stopping me. Are we able to escape somewhere?
Oh, he was running at me. I was trying to click the stick so it would tell me where to go. Nah, through there. So I wonder if we have to like lure it to this wall. Jeez. Huh. Does it come towards us on?
I don't know. Oh, that made it come towards me. I shot at it.
Oh.
It just like launched towards me.
Getting somewhere. Oh shit. Back up. Back up. Get out of the way.
Stay out of his path.
Oh shit.
Like stand where we needed to break through and then shoot it and run out of the way?
I guess. Hey, what? What's this thing? Switch here.
That's what we used to turn it on in the first place. Did something.
5% capacity. Resuming operations in 5.
What?
4. 3.
I don't know.
2. 1.
I don't know.
All hands, clear the deck.
Clear the deck. Oh my god, clear the deck.
Oh!
everybody again? Probably.
Whoa. That was awesome.
We just have to oh, Jesus, a guy right here. So we have to. Okay, we have to do it two more times.
Wow.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All hands, clear the deck.
Clear the deck.
They were just running off in the direction of the
tank. Oh, I'm about to die. Oh.
Chapters work.
No. I think we've started a couple chapters today.
Oh.
There was a couple times when I noticed titles on screen, but I didn't see.
Oh, I didn't notice yet.
Jesus.
That's the, it's really everything blends in.
Yeah. Fuck this planet.
Fuck this planet.
Let's get out of here.
Oh yeah. Isaac hates this planet.
Okay, Ellie. We're headed to the warehouse now.
Right. Is everything okay?
Oh yeah, between this planet trying to kill us.
Yeah, have we even hit it? Your boyfriend hated me. Or does it just save?
This has been a
I didn't
not
see it save
like
so
this.
Far.
I don't know why.
Just let us fight it out, okay?
It's gotta be
one
showing
of us
up
will
soon.
Win eventually. Did you find the experiment?
Yes.
And
you'll just have to see it.
That's some good tandem stomping. This is one of those classic elevators that only works with two people on it.
Mm-hmm.
The like sign there said it even. That's ridiculous.
Yeah, it's always frustrating when you come across one of those in real life when you're by yourself. You're like, oh, I gotta get a stranger now.
Gotta go get a stranger or a big dummy.
Beautiful.
Oh, artifact. There's just a lot of rooms like that in this.
Yeah.
Or what's the point of any of what we just did?
Yeah.
Holy shit.
Isaac, there you are. We're upstairs on the observation level.
What the hell is this?
It's bad news, that's what it is.
Beautiful, isn't it? The scientists called it the Nexus. They thought these bigger specimens acted as conduits for the machine's control signal, broadcasting it to the smaller forms.
And that helps us how?
Because I think they found the machine by tracking the signal upstream through nerve clusters inside the creature.
Oh, wait. We need to get inside that thing?
Yes! This is such a wonderful opportunity.
Wonderful opportunity. The son of a bitch is frozen solid. How do we get in?
The scientists used heat exchangers. Let me try to ignite them. No, no good.
There's probably a furnace on the roof. If I can find it,
I can get it running.
Why would you think there's a furnace on
it? Probably. It's just probably.
Yeah, don't hurt yourself.
Odds are.
I've been to places like this before.
I mean, like, yeah, I got a progress saving in the top right there.
Oh, yeah, there we go. Yeah, that's probably the good spot. Yeah. Oh, cool. Our blue and red guys can keep on going.
Oh, great. We finally got played some more Dull Spice.
Mm-hmm. I think we made some good key progress.
Yeah, some good team progress.
Yeah. Oh, right. It tells us we're at 42.5% complete. I don't know if that means, like, I don't know if 100 is, like,
right,
getting everything or not, yeah. But.
Wow. Yeah. Sire says there's nothing scarier than an enthusiastic scientist.
Oh, that's absolutely true.
Yep. Yeah.
That's why I make sure to tell every scientist I meet that I don't like them and don't be enthusiastic.
Yeah. Don't, like, yeah, just stick to the simple stuff.
Stick to the simple stuff, like a better mouse trap.
Yeah, exactly. Whiter teeth.
Oh, yeah, but not at the expense of other people.
No.
Makeup for dogs, but don't test it on animals.
Don't test it on dogs.
Yeah.
Just make it for the dogs.
Oh, then the dogs can choose to wear it if they want to.
Don't make them wear it.
Yeah.
Test it on people that look like dogs.
I still think makeup for dogs is one of the greatest inventions of all time.
Oh, yeah. I don't know how it works.
I would never make a dog wear makeup either, but boy, oh boy, do they need it.
Well, we got to go plan next week because that was a Friday show.
Yeah.
Thanks so much for watching Cyrus Black and Tiny Observer and LSKC and Games Ideas Maker.
Oh, boy.
That was super fun. Mm-hmm. Oh, and Bruno Brand.
Oh, boy. Yeah. Even more.
Awesome people.
Awesome people.
There will be more Dead Space next week, probably. Well, probably some 50, more 50. Mario next week.
Yeah.
Maybe some Kirby, maybe some Star Tropics and Portal 2.
Who knows? Crazy.
We got a lot on the go.
Look at that happen. Right before your eyes or whatever.
Hopefully we'll see you there. Have a great night, everybody.
Yeah.
And keep swizzling those sticks.
They're all in the new world.